While it is true that the sun has set on a beautiful day here in Saginaw, Michigan, in the Saginaw Bay Arena, there is still plenty of time left on this Saturday for what is sure to be an incredible college hockey game. Tonight, the Chippewas are back in action, looking to take revenge on their close loss to the Cardinals of Saginaw Valley State University just a night ago. Happy Halloween and welcome inside the broadcast booth. This is Reagan Cleaves, and I'll be guiding you through this one as the Central Michigan Chippewas have made the 50-mile trip east to take on the Saginaw Valley State Cardinals and wrap up their weekend home and home series. Well, last night it was one heck of a hockey game between these two teams at Martin Ice Arena in Mount Pleasant. It was a really close game, back and forth all night. And surprisingly, despite that being that back and forth, it was a scoreless hockey game for the majority of the 60 minutes. In the first period, shots on goal were 19-14 in favor of Saginaw Valley State. And they had all the pressure in the offensive zone. They were testing Thomas Rofe, the Central Michigan netminder, left and right, getting chances here and there. For the most part, their strategy seemed to be to get pucks up top to the blue lines and throw them down low and set up bodies out in front and hope for deflections, screens, whatever, to test Thomas Rofe. And it was working. They were getting many, many really good chances, but they couldn't pot any of them. And at the end of one, it was scoreless. 0-for-1 the power play went the Chippewas. 0-for-2 went the Cardinals. Moving on to the second period at 5:41, Rayner went off for a cross check to put the Chippewas on a power play that couldn't capitalize. Same thing at 9:31. Nemeth went off for a trip to put the Chippewas again on the power play. They couldn't capitalize on any of that, and they went 0-for-2 in that period, falling to 0-for-3 on the evening. And then at 16:40 of that second period, there was an incident involving Ben Rychuk. Rychek. He took Kennedy McHugh to the boards, threw him down, and started throwing haymakers at his head. They both got away with. They both were sent to the box for 14 minutes apiece. Both of them getting 10-minute misconducts, 2 minutes for roughing, and 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct. But throughout that second period, both netminders were absolutely stellar, and including going into that final frame in the second. Jacob Witt is the starting netminder for the Saginaw Valley State Cardinals. Stopped 20 of 20 in that second period, and to bring them up to 34. For 34 on the night, Thomas Rofe stopped all 30 through the first 40 minutes that the Cardinals had sent on them, and they weren't any routine saves. Jacob Winters made a couple of incredible saves in that second and the start of the third. When your opponent is putting pressure on, and you've got to be able to get in passing lanes, break up passes, and be able to gain control for your team so you can go ahead and get into the offensive end.
Well, he took a risk. Redirected in front. Nady tried to go in the backhand. Gets the paddle there. Winters to knock it down. He still holds it behind the net. Porzo tried to throw one in front. No one held. And it comes back down the other way. My goodness, the best chance of the night for the Chippewas.
Yeah, the Cardinals have been in their own zone for a long time here, Reagan.
Yeah,
they finally get it out.
This is almost the polar opposite of the first period. It's been all action in the Saginaw Valley. And now
a timer chance. Oh, my goodness.
He just
robbed Isaac Gibbs on the one-timer feed. My goodness.
Oh, my goodness. Indeed. Winters was dead to rights with the pass right across the crease and on the backdoor side, Isaac Gibbs, and he put it, unfortunately, exactly where Winters was, and
yeah,
that was right on the ice. It looked like Isaac Gibbs had all the time in the world to bury it, but he got no elevation on it, and that's why it remains a scoreless game.
Dangerous
for the Cardinals, and now the Chippewas have a rushing back the other way.
With Jacobson Andre, feeds in front for St. Andre. A chance in front, saved by Winters in the blocker. Another try by Lasky. Comes to the other side. Great stop by Winters, and they have to get it out of the zone and reset.
Those were some incredible saves by those two net miners. All those clips were of Jacob Winters making some incredible saves. However, Thomas Rofe also did his fair share, making a couple of key saves, but the goaltender's luck could not hold forever, and the luck came to an end when at 11:59 of the third, Marshall opened up the scoring to put Saginaw Valley State in front.
Hudson and Simon Selly along over there trying to help as a group of players. The referee is urging them to get it out of the end boards. It's Cooper trying to get it out now. He will, and it will be taken here by Travis Namath, and they'll skate up for it. 3-on-2 chance for the Cardinals. They skate in along to Namath. Tries to go backhand shot. They score! On the backhand for the Cardinals on a 3-on-2 chance. They make this a 1-0 game. That's Brennan Marshall with the goal.
For Brennan Marshall, he was able to corral that bouncing puck in the slot and put it high short side past Thomas Rofe. And that's a goal that, as a goaltender, you can't really do much about. It's a bouncing puck out in front of you. You want to get down to be able to make sure that puck doesn't squeeze underneath you. But also that leaves open the top part of the net unless you can't get out.
Yeah, that was a really good goal by Marshall, picking up a bouncing puck and working into the slot and moving it high over the right shoulder of Thomas Rofe. And that is, despite the Chippewas' best efforts as time would go on, they would end up pulling Thomas Rofe, but they couldn't generate any good opportunities and thus fell to 3-1 on the year. Jacob Winters had an astounding 52 save shutout. His first shot of the 21-22 campaign. Thomas Rofe also played fantastic, stopping 40 of 41. Now that we've taken a look at what preceded this game, let's take a look around the MCHC ahead of tonight's matchup. Taking a look around the West Division in particular tonight, Lawrence Tech leads the way with 15 points. They've got a record of 5-5. They've played 10 games, the most out of any team in the MCHC West. They're followed closely behind, though, by Oakland, who sits at 4-4-1 through 9 games, 13 points. And those two are far and ahead the top two teams thus far, at least overall in the MCHC West. Central Michigan, the Chippewas follow them right close behind, sitting third in the MCHC with a record of 3-1, 9 points. And they are deadlocked at 9 points with their opponent tonight, Saginaw Valley State, who, with that win last night over the Chippewas, improved to 3-2. But by dint of the Chippewas having more points per game, as they have played fewer games than the Cardinals, they sit above them in the standings. Michigan, the Michigan Wolverines sit at 2-2, 6 points on the year. They lost to Hope College yesterday. They're actually in the midst of a battle out in Holland right now. They're followed behind, and they're deadlocked with Adrian at 6 points. But again, Michigan playing one fewer game. Adrian sits at 2-3. And rounding out the conference standings, Michigan Flint sits dead last, 0-2, with no points thus far. Central Michigan, coming into this contest, sits 24th in the ACHA. They're 0-1 in conference by way of that loss last night against Saginaw Valley State. And thus far, they've only played one game on the road in which they beat the Davenport Panthers by a final of 5-0. As for Saginaw Valley State, as we said earlier, they come in 3-2 with 9 points, 25th in the ACHA, right on the heels of Central Michigan. They are 2-1 in conference with 6 points, and they are 1-1 here in the friendly confines of Saginaw Bay Arena. And, of course, their last game came as a win against Central Michigan. That win last night for Saginaw Valley brought them within one win in the series record of Central Michigan since the 1920 campaign. Central Michigan swept that series in 1920, and then SVSU looking to return the favor tonight here after that 1-0 win yesterday at Martin. Moving on to the lineups here tonight. Scratches for Central Michigan. Luke Wild is out along with Alex Lasky. Luke Wild is out. Lasky is in. Austin Ritter is out. Hayden Flynn is out. Darsh Kashyap, Lauren Jones, and Cullen Smith round out the scratches. As for Saginaw Valley, they've got a bit of a lineup situation here. Their starting netminder, Ryan Foreman, is out with an undisclosed injury. So that means due to ACHA rules, you have to dress two netminders. So they have pulled Corey Churchill in for e-bug duties. He is the emergency backup netminder tonight, taking one defenseman away from the Cardinals. Other scratches, Jacob Martin, Ricky Rayner, Kennedy McHugh, Nick Broski, Hunter Overall, Colton Gayakumbo. Now moving on to players to watch for tonight for Central Michigan. One holdover from last night's players to watch, Owen Campbell, who has 6 points through four games, 2 goals, 4 assists. He's made a fantastic impression as a freshman for these Chippewas. He has been able to rack up some points, able to distribute the puck very well. He's a very good addition along with his former teammate and current teammate, as he played at the same high school as Jacob Kosnick, who along with Owen Campbell came from Jackson Lumen Christie as they graduated last year. Thomas Rofe, the other Chippewa to watch. This is his fifth game. This is his third game. He's 2-1, 0.75 goals against average, and a .961 save percentage. He has been very good all season for the Chippewas in those first three games, and he made a couple of key saves last night to keep the Chippewas in it. As for Saginaw Valley State, Stephen Kukla, who through five games has 8 points, 4 goals, 4 assists. He was a very good player last night, got a couple of opportunities, was unable to break the back of the net, however. And as for SVSU's netminder, Jacob Wears, he, as we mentioned earlier, was absolutely fantastic. Although he got a little bit lucky on a couple of those plays, he still stopped everything the Chippewas threw at him, and he improved with that win to 2-0. He's got an even one goals against average and an incredible 97.8 save percentage. He is going to get this start tonight, and it should be a great goaltending matchup, as it was last night. And now we take a look at our keys to the game. Jacob Winters was a puzzle that the Chippewas just had no idea how to solve last night. They threw everything and the kitchen sink at the sophomore netminder for the Cardinals. He stopped everything, although it took a couple of Chippewas missing on some wide open nets, but he still was able to fight off everything, and that's something the Chippewas have to do. They have to get him moving. They have to find the weakness behind Jacob Winters, or this is going to be another low-scoring contest here tonight. They also have to clear out the front of the defensive goal. The Chippewas last night had a tough time defensively. They had to block a lot of shots, and the ones they did block often turned into chances for Saginaw Valley because the Cardinals were just working the pucks up to the point, letting shots go with traffic out in front, hoping for deflection, a bouncing puck, something to change direction and fool Rofe. And although they didn't get the goal off of that, that is something that cannot happen. It cannot happen tonight. They need to shut down on those deflections out in front. Well, that will do it for this portion of the pregame show, but stay with us. Before we come back for the national anthem and puck drop, we bring you today's edition of the Coaches Show, where I sat down with Coach Tyler Cataline at tonight's contest in the newest edition of the Coaches Show. Here's our conversation.
Hello and welcome to this edition of the Coach's Show here on CCHN. I'm Reagan Cleaves, and welcome in Coach Tyler Cataline once again for this pregame interview ahead of this road tilt against Saginaw Valley State. Well, Coach, you guys are coming off of a rough 1-0 loss last night, in which your team fought hard all night but just couldn't capitalize on the opportunities that you guys had. How do you keep you guys motivated to bounce back last night, or bounce back tonight, off of a tough loss last night?
I'll just stick to our game plan. I mean, we we outplayed them. I mean, we outshot them 52 to 41 or something like that. I mean, had a lot of opportunities. Missed, you know, a few open nets. You know, Rofi stood on his head for us in net. So, you know, not going to change much. I mean, just keep to our game plan and hopefully walk out with a W.
Yeah, it sounds like a good plan. I mean, last night it seemed like Saginaw Valley was doing its best to cycle pucks up to the blue line and shoot for redirections out in front. They didn't end up getting a goal with it, but they certainly were generating their fair share of chances. How do you plan to counteract that in tonight's game?
We'll stick with what we, you know, after the first period, we noticed that they were getting everything to the point. So, you know, second, third period, we started putting guys, you know, we made it a 3-on-3 down low and just had our wingers stay on their points, and it took a lot of their opportunities away. So we'll stick with that this tonight, and, you know, like I said, hopefully, you know, take away their scoring opportunities.
Yeah, and I mean, it worked for you guys last night. They ended up getting a fluky goal off of a bounce up in front. SVSU and this Saginaw Bay Arena, known for their raucous crowds, often packing the barn with 600 to 800 fans. That's safe to say is one of the biggest crowds, not only in the MCHC, but possibly in all Division III on any given night. Does the hostility of such a large crowd factor into how you prepare your players for a game like this?
Oh, hopefully we jump on them early and just shut the crowd up right away, you know, so. But, yeah, I mean, the guys are looking forward to playing in a, you know, a barn like this with so many people. And, you know, there's a lot of history, you know, at Saginaw with, you know, their fans and stuff like that. So, guys are ready. You know, hopefully we just take the fans right out of it early in the game and, you know, they're never going to be a factor.
Yeah, certainly. I mean, walking around the barn before this interview, right after we got here, it's certainly got its history, it's got its character, and I'm excited to call a game here tonight. One more question here as we wrap up this installment of the Coaches Show. Last night, SVSU was down to one netminder, Jacob Winters. Playing in his second game of the season, the sophomore goaltender stood on his head all night and was certainly also the benefactor of some fortuitous bounces. If he does get the start tonight, which is what we expect with their number one goaltender, Ryan Foreman, out of the lineup once again, what can you do to beat him here tonight?
Just keep peppering him. I mean, he got lucky. I mean, not going to lie, yesterday. I mean, he played great.
Yeah.
But, you know, a lot of them, you know, there was a few chances. I mean, 7 or 8 of them that, you know, he got lucky on. But, you know, I mean, and I'm not trying to take anything away from him. I mean, he won that game for him, and, you know, kudos to him. But, you know, we're just going to keep peppering him and hopefully put a few past him tonight.
Yeah, hopefully you guys can do that, and good luck tonight, Coach. Well, that does it for our Coaches Show. Thank you always, Tyler, for taking the time to talk with me. We will take a break, but stand by. National Anthem's starting lineups and puck drop for this one await you on the other side. You're listening to the Chippewas D3 Hockey on CCHN.
A great rendition of the national anthem by the Saginaw Valley State Hockey Band. That's something you don't often see, and I'm glad I get to see it. Starting netminders tonight, Thomas Rolf gets the start for Central Michigan. He's 2-1, a .75 goals against average, and a save percentage of 9.61. As for Jacob Winters, the SVSU starting netminder, 2-0, 1.00 goals against average, 9.78 save percentage. Starting lineups, Porzondik, Hayes, Lasky, McComas, and Nadu for the Chippewas. And for the Cardinals, Brandon Marshall, Brett Nelson, Travis Nemeth, Zach Hudson, and Ethan Schneider. Left to right go the Chippewas in their maroon uniforms with the gold helmets, gold trim, gold numerals, maroon pants with a gold stripe on the side, and maroon socks. Saginaw Valley counters right to left, wearing their white home uniforms, blue shoulders, blue numerals, red pants, and white socks. Puck drop at center. We are underway here at Saginaw Bay Ice Arena. Back in their own end, the Cardinals control across the way. It's taken there by Nemeth. Nemeth up right wing, or up left wing near Nelson. He lost the puck, and it'll be sent back into the Cardinal end. Back behind Winters to my right. It's wrapped around the boards by the Cardinals. Kept in by Lasky. A shot through traffic. That caught Jacob Winters by surprise, but he made the save. And the Cardinals will gain the red line and throw it around the boards. 30 seconds gone here in period number one. Moving up right wing, McComas splits the defense, but he lost the puck in the process. And it's picked up there by Zach Hudson. Hudson up right wing, off of a skate to Sawyer. Sawyer working to the top of the slot, a shot. That hit Chapman out in front. It's played behind now, pass out in front, shut off there by Christopher Martin. Puck played in the right wing corner, Chippewa and to our left. It's played 2-on-2 in the corner. It comes out and St. Andre will backhand that out to center. It's intercepted there by Bruce McLean. McLean will throw it into the near corner and behind Thomas Rolf. 1:20 gone here in period number one. Scoreless through the first couple of minutes here, or through the first minute here at Saginaw Bay Ice Arena. Chippewas are able to steal the puck in the defensive end, and St. Andre moves up left wing, over the line left side. Oh, working on the circle, feeding it in front. It hit a skate intended for Cooper. Puck played behind the net, and St. Andre has taken the boards. Zamboni doors here at Saginaw Bay Ice Arena as that sent down the ice for icing against the Cardinals. Draw will come all the way back into the Cardinal end to the right of Winters. The Zamboni doors here at Saginaw Bay Ice Arena actually lift up. They don't open out of the rink. They're set up on a rig where they will lift up to let the Zamboni pass underneath. And that's definitely a nice quirk among many here at the Old Barn, here at Saginaw Bay Ice Arena. They get some pretty big crowds here in the section to my left, with the student section and whatnot. They are pretty much packed to the gills over there. Now a shot from the point, shot from the left point off of Austin Whaley's stick is deflected up and above the Zamboni doors into the netting. So we'll have a stoppage of play here. A minute and 47 gone here in period number one. Draw on the left wing circle, digging in, it'll be Joey Simoncelli. We have a faceoff violation, Jordan Cooper and his man Aaron Shaheen, the alternate captain for the Cardinals, infringed on the faceoff circle. Saginaw Valley able to control the loose puck on the near side, and they'll throw it around the boards. Outlet pass, good touch there to McClellan. McClellan steps around a check, moves it ahead. Here's Carter. Carter let a shot go from the hash marks outside of the right wing circle. It was deflected wide. Puck played behind the net. Now McClellan digs it out, but it's intercepted by the Chippewa. St. Andre had that knocked off his stick, but the Cardinals got it, a shot right on. And it's knocked away to the corner by Rove, and a penalty coming up here on the Chippewas here at the 2:22 mark. Taken down was Aaron Shaheen, into the box goes Austin Whaley. So the Chippewas will head on a penalty kill here at 2:22. J.
Chippewas win the defensive zone draw, and they'll throw it around the boards to the near side. Austin Whaley off 2 minutes for a trip. Chippewas get it in the center of the length of the ice. Caromed off the side of the net. Jacob Winters left it there for his defenseman. Right to left charge the Cardinals here on this power play. Kukla over the line, cross ice feed. They'll get it in the right circle, pass into the slot. Another pass was intercepted, and now there's a breakaway for Keegan Moore. Over the line, left side, one man back. It's his opposite number. Now he'll try to get around him, and he lost an edge and will go tumbling into the net and will cause a stoppage of play, knocking it off its moorings. 1:25 left in the man advantage. There'll be a draw at neutral ice right in front of the Saginaw Valley bench. The benches here at Saginaw Bay Ice Arena are very long, the longest I've ever seen, at least the non-glassed part is. I'm not sure how far down the benches go, but pretty much they span from just to the side of center ice, or just to either side of center ice, and all the way down to the hash marks in each of the defensive zone circles. Now moving up with speed is McLean. McLean into the right wing circle. He'll throw it around the boards to the near side. It's picked up there by McLaughlin. Rawling. Rawling will throw it wide, and the rebound popped off the end boards. And right on the doorstep there was Bruce McLean, but Thomas Rofe sealed the right post. And with a minute and five gone here in the Whaley Minor, there'll be another draw in the Chippewa end. This one, it's in the right wing circle. Simon Sully to dig in with Nemeth. Puck tied up across the way. St. Andre's able to bat it out, and it'll go back into the Saginaw end. Two more right. 16:24 left here in period number one. Scoreless here through the first 3 minutes and change. Now moving up right wing, here's Nemeth. Nemeth across that line, right side, cross ice feed to Carter. Carter in the left circle, drop pass for Rowling. He's able to push it over, a shot, and save the rebound, they score! Troy McLaughlin on the doorstep. Potted the rebound after the shot from the right wing circle, and Thomas Rofe, both netminders had some trouble with rebound control last night, and it finally pays off. And it finally works to their detriment, rather. And at 3:54, it's 1-0 Saginaw Valley State. So the Cardinals win the draw. Now good pressure on the back check by Owen Campbell. Pass out right in front. Oh, my goodness. That was sent just wide of the left post there by Isaac Gibbs on the doorstep. He intercepts a pass. Top of the left wing circle. He'll work down. Here's the announcement on the goal. Now here's a breakaway down the right wing. A shot to lift it over the net. So McLaughlin from McLean at Rowling at 3:54. That shot off of the breakaway there. It was a 2-on-1. Garrett Sawyer worked down the right wing and into the right circle. He lifted that just over the net of Thomas Rofe. It was ruled that Rofe deflected it up. Now a shot from the right point. His block to the corner. That's thrown out in front. And Chippewas get it to the line, but not out. Good keep there by Shaheen. Now Owen Campbell picks it up left wing. He'll move into the neutral zone and center the Cardinal line. Chippewa's gotten a line change here. Moving up, here's McClellan. McClellan taken down there by Jordan Cooper. Good defensive play there. Chippewa's regain the puck at neutral ice and send it deep. Near side, McLean throws it around to the far side. It's thrown off the end boards near side, intercepted at center by St. Andre. Over the line right side. He'll walk the line, send it across. Cooper left wing circle, fires a shot over the net. It comes to the near side, kept in by Lasky right point. He sends it across. Cooper had a bounce off his stick, kept in there by Hayes. He'll chip it down low off the glass to Gennad Karam. It's played behind the net to the near side, and the Cardinals send it the length of the ice. Icing is waved off, is beating his man to the puck. There was Brandon Marshall. He had the lone goal last night in the Cardinal win. Just over 5.5 gone here in period number one. 1-0, the Cardinals lead on an early power play goal. A pass up top is intercepted in his own right wing circle by St. Andre, and he'll clear it out to center off the half wall.
Rowling, who assisted on that goal. He got the second assist. McLean had the shot from the top of the right circle. And that was, and the rebound of which was put home by McLaughlin. It's played to the near side. Chippewas gain control to 2-1-1. Simon Tully across the line right side. He sends it across. And Andre moving in. Oh, my goodness. What a stop by the right pad of Winters. And there's a delayed penalty coming up. Up at the top. A shot through traffic. And it's going to be a 5-on-3 as another penalty was called. We've got two penalties here. A trip on one hand. And are we going to have a second penalty? There's a trip to Nemeth. Nemeth is to the box, and the Chippewas are going to have a 5-on-3. Here, timing the penalties. 6:06 here, and the Chippewas are on the power play here. Nemeth to the box, along with... We'll wait to see the announcement. We don't have number 18 right now. Drawing the offensive end, the Chippewas win it and look to go to work here in the 5-on-3. Worked up top and back down to Cooper, feeding it across. It went off of Lasky's skate in the corner. Trey Morgan whistled off for the cross check. Chippewas set it up top, a shot! Off of the stick of Brennan Martin, the Central Michigan captain, goes up and out of play, and we will have a stoppage of play. 27 seconds gone in the two-man advantage here. 1-0, the Cardinals lead, but they've gifted a golden opportunity here to the Chippewas, 5-on-3 for a full 2 minutes. Digging it'll be Owen Campbell. He'll win the draw to the half boards and go to get it himself in the right corner. He'll wrap it around the boards. Kept in up top there by Martin. Christopher Martin on the defense. He'll walk the line. Throw a wrist shot in front. Caroms off the end boards after deflected wide. His brother Brennan Martin controls right wing. Down to St. Andre down low. He'll work into the circle. Feed a pass across. One touch pass to Martin up top. Across. Back up to Gibbs. His shot. Floated up in the air just over Jacob Winter's net. 1:06 to go. Pass across. Deflected. Good defensive play there by Bruce McLean. And the puck will come out with a minute left in the 5-on-3. Owen Campbell across the way. It's taken in by Gibbs. Left wing circle. He was hit in the head. How was that not a penalty? He got a clean shoulder to the head. That's got to be head contact. Yet no referee puts his arm up. He tried to split the defense, got a clean shoulder to the head, and he's down in a heap. That's the second Chippewa that's gone down with a head injury in the last two games. First of all, it was Jacob St. Andre taking a tumble into the left wing corner yesterday. Now the referees are talking about it. Isaac Gibbs makes his way to the bench, checks off his helmet, throws it down. He is not happy at all. He's got to be careful there. And they are not going to call a penalty on this. This is absolutely ridiculous. He got clipped in the head, and there's no call. My goodness. It remains a 5-on-3, 48 seconds left. Cardinals win the draw, control back in their own end, and lift it down the ice. Brennan Martin back at his own line to plant. Left and right go the Chippewas. Here in period number one, they got 37 seconds left on that power play. 5-on-3. Worked down into the far corner, Simon Selle. In the left corner, sends it up top to Lasky, left point. He'll send it near side to Brendan Martin. Martin across to Lasky, a one-timer shot, and a big glove save there by Jacob Winters. 24 seconds gone here in period number, 24 seconds left in the 5-on-3. Nemeth and Morgan whistled off simultaneously. Face-off violation, so we'll redo the face-off in the left-wing circle. Morgan was whistled off after the delayed penalty had been shown. Now the Chippewas are unable to keep it in at the line. 17 to go on the 5-on-3. Brennan Martin fires it across to Alex Lasky. Lasky moving through center near side to Cooper. Cooper over the line right side. He'll feed it up to the top of the slot. Lasky holds. He'll let a shot go just wide of the net. 5 seconds to go on the man advantage. It's kept at the line by Cooper right side. He'll work into the slot. Let a shot go off the crossbar. My goodness. Now Cooper, he's taken down. And there's going to be an icing is waved off. Saginaw Valley wanting a penalty on forthcoming. Now feed out in front. Good defensive play there by Brennan Martin to knock the puck away and out to center. It's lifted to the near side. Bruce McLean back there to play it for the for the Cardinals. Top left wing, working here is Baker. Baker over the line, let a shot go, saving the rebound, loose in front. Now there's a fight behind, and we're going to have simultaneous minors here. It'll be Christopher Martin, and whistle off simultaneously with him. It's going to be number 32, Brandon Hacker. So it is Hacker, and Martin. Time will be 8:41. So Martin and Hunter whistled off for a cross check. 4-on-4 to start for the next 2 minutes here. Chippewas win the draw on their own end, and it's thrown around the boards to the far side. Charlie Hayes will return the favor near side to Kyle Chapman. Chapman pinned up along the boards, works it ahead to McComas up right wing. McComas worked over. Good defensive play there on the back check. There by Dornseifer. It's played to the near corner. Saginaw Valley controls. Just over 9 minutes gone here in period number one, and a big collision at center. Rayner picks up the puck left wing. He's working in, a pass out in front. Pardon me, that's Schneider. He had the puck knocked away from him after a sharp angle shot was stopped by Rove. 10:40 to go here, a pass across. McComas couldn't handle the intercept, and it's picked up by Schneider. Schneider will play it off of the corner boards, working there to get it to Stephen Kukla. Kukla playing catch there with Zach Hudson. Both these two players started earlier tonight. It's played around the boards to the near side. Hudson pinching down low. Porzondik working there for the Chippewas. Puck played up at center ice. They have a chance for a 2-on-1, but Kyle Chapman and Andrew Porzondik combine to negate that chance. 10:07 to go here in period one. 1-0 Saginaw Valley and the Chippewas. Working up through center here. Sawyer let a shot go, saving the rebound, and Thomas Rope again has trouble with another rebound. He's unable to corral it first opportunity. He's lucky enough that he is able to pounce on that one. And with 37 seconds left in the 4-on-4, we got 9:55 left in the first period. Fans, don't forget that CMU Club Hockey Network YouTube channel is your one-stop shop for highlights, exclusive interviews, and full game broadcasts for CMU D3 hockey. Make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so as never to miss a moment of Chippewa hockey. Just go to YouTube and search CMU Club Hockey Network to find the YouTube channel. Shot right off the draw was corralled by Rofe. Another shot that he wasn't able to control first time. Chippewas win the ensuing draw. St. Andre cutting through center ice ahead to Owen Campbell. Drop pass to nobody in particular. Austin Whaley working down low, a bouncing puck right on. And Jacob Winters is able to hold on for a whistle with 22 left in the 4-on-4. Again, the 4-on-4 was given to Hacker and Martin at 8:41 for a 4-on-4. Draw to the left is one up to the line, but nobody home there for the Chippewas. It's played to the near side up in the air. It's gloved by Brennan Martin. Across to his defensive partner, Austin Whaley. Haley will play it up through center. It's corralled there by Aiden Gazdecki. He returns to the lineup tonight. He's worked over at center, and the Cardinals regain control and throw it behind Thomas Rove. Both players out of the box. We return to 5-on-5. So 4-on-4 goes nowhere. Chippewas 0 for 2 on the penalty, and another hit up high on Austin Whaley. And now pass out in front, and Thomas Rove makes the save point blank on Travis Nemeth. What a save there by Thomas Rofe as Nemeth was set up on the back door. A feed came from the left side, and Thomas Rofe shuts the five hole. And with 10:54 gone here in the first, draw will come into the left wing circle of the Chippewa and two on the left. That's the second hit in just the first 11 minutes where the Chippewas have had the Chippewas player has gone down holding his head, and that's like the Isaac Gibbs one. He definitely took a shoulder to the head, but the one on Austin Whaley just looked like incidental contact, looked like he got rattled a little bit. Rolfe makes the save from the right, finish up from the right point. And he'll draw a draw in the right circle. One by the Chippewas, Charlie Hayes gets it to the line and out, but it was played at the Chippewa bench. So it went up and out of play, so the draw will come back to the Chippewa. And once again, draws won by the Chippewas, and they'll go to work in the defensive end, trying to get it out of breakout pass to Gazdecki, and a big hit. And then here in the defensive end, going down was Alex Lasky, delivering the hit was Brett Nelson. And another collision. This series has been physical for both of these two games, and they've ramped up the intensity here in the first half of the first period. Chippewas throw it in behind Winners. Loose puck. Isaac Gibbs threw it out in front. Nobody was there for the Chippewas. Alex Lasky took a one-timer, and it was blocked. And a big hit just inside the line. Brandon Baker, the recipient of that hit. And that could have been too many men on the ice. Now a shot from the left circle is deflected up off of the stick of Jacob Winners. And up and out of play. We'll have a draw on the Saginaw Valley end to our left. To our right, pardon. The left wing circle. Owen Campbell to dig in with Zach Dornseifer. Dornseifer will win the draw back, and the Cardinals will look to break out here. Down left wing, Sawyer, a pass across, goes up into the Chippewa bench. It was unable to be gloved by Jacob St. Andre. We'll say having a band in an ice arena is a very novel experience. I tried 3 years to get my band director in high school to do a hockey band, but much to my chagrin, that never came to fruition. They've certainly been playing very well, at least in the first half of this first period. Yeah, play now down in the Chippewa end. Back defensively, there is Kyle Chapman trying to start the breakout for the Maroon and Gold. He was working at his own line. He's forced to retreat. Near side, Christopher Martin across to Chapman. Chapman up right wing off of the skate of Campbell, and that will be waved off. As obviously, it was touched by Campbell before it crossed the red line. Puck free behind the net. Now pass out in front, sliding puck, and it was. And it was blown dead in the crease, and they're saying the faceoff will come out. Evidently, they thought it was covered by the Chippewas or a hand pass. So it'll come out to the near side, far side neutral dot on the Saginaw Bay end. 7:27 remaining here in period number one. Draw is won, and the Chippewas, and they'll retreat back to their own line. Brennan Martin, the captain, moves it to the Cardinal land, but it was knocked down there, and the two teams exchange the puck at center. It's played up, gloved down there by Broski. Broski working in the left circle, fanned on the puck, and Brennan Martin takes him to the boards. Now a loose puck to the side of the net. It's cleared to the slot, a backhand shot, and they to the side of the net, and it just trickled wide. That was a bouncing puck that just trickled wide to the left post. Saginaw still has possession of the offensive end. Rattling a shot from the left circle is blocked, and St. Andre controls the rebound. He will send it the length of the ice. Icing will be the call against the Chippewas. 6:40 to go here in period number one. This game has been back and forth, rapid action from the old barn here in Saginaw. We talked about a couple of their quirks already, the long benches and the fact that this is packed to the gills almost every night. Now a loose puck off the draw. It couldn't be handled there by McLaughlin, bidding for his second of the night. Puck loose in the Chippewa, and it hit the referee. McLaughlin behind the net into the right circle, benefiting from the puck off of the referee. He lets a shot go from the hash marks along the boards, and it's gloved down easily by the left catching glove of Thomas Rolfe. We talked about some quirks. The band is actually not in the normal grandstand. They've got a mezzanine working from the end of the grandstand to the right of me here. The grandstand ends at about the hash marks in what is now the Saginaw Valley end. Now a pass ahead. McComas couldn't find the puck. So the puck will come back into the Saginaw Valley end. And it's a whole other level of bleachers. It's something I've never seen, and I've come to really like it in the short time here. And there's an offside on the Cardinals across the way. We'll have a stoppage of play with 14 minutes exactly gone here in period number one. The old wooden bleachers. The band is right along the near is right at the far left end, but it wraps around to directly behind Jacob Winters. So you've got that second level of seating to our right, and it's old wooden bleachers. It gives this barn some character, and this is one of the most intriguing arenas that I have been to in a very long time. Now Porzondik working down right wing, let a shot from a sharp angle go. It was blocked. Alex Lasky let one fly from the right point. It also went wide. Now pass up to the point. Chapman lost it. It's a 3-on-2. Left side, here's Marshall over the line. Oh, we're getting the slot. Had it knocked away. Good defensive play is coming back. There was Joey Simoncelli. Pardon me, Jay Nadu. Jay Nadu will work with speed, and he's getting slashed from behind. How is there no call on that? Justin McComas works into the right circle. Good defensive play there by the Cardinals to be able to work that away. Now, Jacob Kosnick plays it back for Charlie Hayes across the way. He'll work it to the Saginaw line, but it was his pass was intercepted. And a good intercept there on the near side by Ben Rychek. Ahead to Rychek from Charlie Hayes. It went off of his stick. Picking that up is Dorn Seifer. Dorn Seifer, under 5 to go here in period number one. It's worked up to the left point. McLean let a shot go. Deflected wide off of the stick of Christopher Martin. It's kept in at the line, but the Chippewas sent a pass off the near side. And it was intercepted by the Cardinals as that came out of the zone. And Kukla will lift it into the opposite corner across the way. 4:31 to go in period number one. 1-0. The Cardinals lead off of an early power play goal from McLaughlin. Working up right side. Rychek just got knocked from behind by Dornsheimer. Now pass out in front! And on the doorstep, Ben Rychek is denied. A point-blank save there by Jacob Winters as the loose puck came from the left-wing corner. And about 5 feet out in front, Ben Rychek found some Halloween candy out in front. But Jacob Winters had some different ideas and turned it from a treat into a trick. Now played back at the Chippewa line. Brennan Martin ahead to Isaac Gibbs. He leaves it there. For Keelan Baker, the Chippewa captain, sends it behind. Jacob Winters out there to play it. Loose puck picked up left wing circle. A shot right on. And it was denied by Winters. It's played up top, wrapped around the boards to the near side. Pinching down is Baker. He sets it up for Gibbs. His shot was blocked, and it's unable to be kept in at the line. Delayed offsides allows the Cardinals to regroup. 3:34 to go in period number one. Loose puck picked up near side. Actually, it wasn't picked up. Two players, one from each side, overskated it. Now an opportunity. Cardinals left wing. A pass out in front. Was denied. 3:21 to go here in period number one. A shot is denied, and the rebound played to the near side. There's going to be a delayed penalty coming up on the Chippewas. Winters hasn't gone yet. I don't think he realizes who's it on. He realizes who it is on, and there'll be a penalty here on the Chippewas to send the Cardinals on the power play once again for the second time tonight. .16:51, the time of the infraction to the box. It is again Austin Whaley. High stick on Austin Whaley. It's worked up to the near side. Cardinals have one for one on the power play thus far today. A shot from the right point was denied off of the stick of Thomas Rofe. Closed the five hole. Now working down low, the Cardinals will play it out in front. Nobody home, and another save by Rofe moving to his left. Denied the one-time opportunity. It's worked up to the point across the way. Near side, Dornsheimer lost control of the puck, and Simoncelli will rush up ice. He's taken down at center. I'm not sure how that's not interference. Now Dorn Cypher with speed left wing. He's across the line in with a shot, and they score! It squeaked under Thomas Rove's pad! He went down into the butterfly. He got a piece of it, but it wasn't enough to stop the puck completely. It worked its way through, and Zach Dorn Cypher gets the Cardinals' second goal, and again, they strike on the power play at 17-36.
Cardinals goal, scored by number 47, Dorn Cypher, assisted by number 16, Garrett Sawyer.
So Dorn Cypher from Sawyer, getting that second Cardinal goal to put them up by two here in the latter stages of the opening 20 minutes. Chippewas gain control at neutral ice, send it behind Winters. We'll wrap it across the way. It's pinched to the boards, and players collide, loose puck behind the net. It's loose to the side of Winters. It's taken out of there by Brandon Marshall. We'll send it to the near side on a cross-ice feed that was to nobody in particular. Raptor across the way, 1:42 to go here in the first period. That goes up and out of play to the Chippewa bench again. So the story of this game thus far has been the special teams. Chippewas 0-2 on the penalty kill. Coming in today, they had a fantastic penalty kill. They had only let up one goal on 13 opportunities, and now they have let up two on two here tonight, and that's just in the first period. Now a bouncing puck thrown across, it caroms off the near corner boards. Alex Lasky down there to play for the Chippewas. He forwards it to Hayes, who moves it out to neutralize. Off the boards, it's intercepted by the alternate captain for the Cardinals, alternate captain Nelson. It's played up top. Jane Adu, right top of the right circle. He let a shot go. It was deflected right onto the stick of Porzondik, but he couldn't do anything with it. Cardinals get it and lift it out to center with 1 minute exactly to go here in the first. Working over the line, drop pass for Porzondik. He's in, and he had his stick lifted, and the puck goes right in on Winters, and he gets an extra shove in the back from Daniel Hudson as he did his best to try and avoid Winters, but nothing will come of that. 52.5 to go here in the first period. Fans, remember to tune in, or remember to stay with us here for the first intermission report. We'll have a look at the Chippewa hockey scoreboard along with the rest of the Chippewa athletics going on this week. And we'll take a look at the ACHA along with a recap so far of proceedings. Cardinals played into the offensive end. Loose puck to the corner. Played near side by Brennan Martin. Loose puck out in front. A shot, a one-timer! Denied! By Thomas Rofe out in front. Garrett Sawyer picked up a pass from the bottom of the left circle, and Thomas Rofe stood tall to make the save from about 15 feet out. 38.2 to go in the period. McLean kept it in. Dorn Cypher looking for his second. Had it knocked away from him, and it was tipped down the ice, so no penalty. Winners out of his net, he'll throw it around the boards. Kept in by Campbell. Campbell throws it down low. It was knocked away from him and is cleared out by Garrett Sawyer. Under 20 to go here. Back in his own end, Brennan Martin, the captain, will send it across the way. Austin Whaley, who had both of the penalties that the Chippewas gave up power play goals on, plays it. It's intercepted by the Cardinals, but they brought it outside of the zone. And now we're offside. 8.9 to go here in the period. Draw it just outside the Chippewa line across the way. Off the tie-up, Chippewas may have it. One last rush. Here's Saint-Andre moving in right side. He's got to get a shot off. Works out in front. And he was denied. And that'll do it for the opening period. We head to the second after 20 minutes of play. The Chippewas trail this one by a score of 2-0. Stand by. We'll be right back with the first intermission report.
Reagan Cleaves back here inside Saginaw Bay Ice Arena after a disappointing first period for the Central Michigan Chippewas. 2:22 into that first, Austin Whaley went off for a trip, and that allowed the Saginaw Bay Chippewas to go to work on the power play, and they made quick work of it. And as at 3:54, Rowling controlled at the left point, passed it across top of the right circle, where McLean let a shot go. Rolf made the initial save, but point right on the nose step was McLaughlin, and was probably Troy McLaughlin, and he put it into the back of the net, passed Thomas Rolf to make it a 1-0 game, 3:54 into the game. And from there, the game only got more physical as Nemeth was sent off for a trip. And during the time of the delayed call there, Morgan cross-checked a man out in front. So the front referee had his arm up. The back referee then put his arm up. And we had a 5-on-3 for the Chippewas. A great chance for them as coming into today, they had a fantastic power play, although they couldn't capitalize last night. They came in on the power play 12%, which is pretty respectable through your first four games, but they could not get anything going. They had a couple of shots, but they were taken away, and nobody was able to capitalize for the Chippewas. So we had a 5-on-3, and in that 5-on-3, Isaac Gibbs moved in on the left side, worked to the top of the left circle, tried to split the defense, and got shouldered in the head. No referee put their arm up. And then they even conferenced afterwards, and Gibbs was down in a heap for a good 10-15 seconds. He eventually gets up, works his way to the bench, and they decide not to call anything, which in the ACHA and the NCAA, that has to be called. Head contact is a 5-minute major and a game misconduct, and that did not happen. And this has been a talking point for the last two games. Referees had interesting works yesterday, some interesting calls yesterday, and that continues here today with a different crew. Then at 8:41, Hecker and Martin were both visited off simultaneously for cross checks. That made it a 4-on-4, nothing going there for either team with the open ice. And then at 16:51, Austin Whaley went off for a high stick to put the Cardinals back on the power play. Dornseifer worked on the left side at 17:36 and let a shot go over the top of the left circle that looked harmless enough. But Thomas Rolf was slow getting down, and he got a piece of it, but it squeaked through him and into the back of the net for the second goal. And it's 2-0 for Saginaw Valley, and that is how we stand at the end of one. Chippewas going 0-for-2 on the power play, while Saginaw doing a great job going, they're going 2-for-2. Now we swivel and take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard. First of all, Chippewa hockey. Neither the men's D2 team or the women's D2 team in action tonight. The men's D2 coming off of a, they actually played earlier today at 1 against Eastern Michigan, and finishing up their weekend series with them. They are in action next weekend against the Roosevelt Lakers on a trip out to Roosevelt. As for the women, they have a weekend home and home against Aquinas next weekend, the 5th and the 6th, 7:30 on Friday and 4 p.m. on Saturday. That Friday game, if we can pull it up here, is going to be at Southside Ice Arena, so that'll be at Aquinas, and then the Saturday game is home against the Saints. Taking a look at the ACHA, some Michigan games. Michigan and Hope College in a tight battle at Edgar's Ice Southwest. Currently, Hope has a 2-goal lead, 7:19 left in the third. Other games tonight as we scroll through the ACHA website. Davenport plays Grand Valley. That game started at 8 p.m. ahead of this contest. Marquette taking on University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee at 7:40 Central.
We've got Calvin taking on Tryon in an MCHC contest at 4:15, and Adrian and the University of Michigan Flint kicking things off at 8. As for Chippewa Athletics, men's cross country working the MAC Championship, Appalachian State played field hockey. Volleyball taking on Buffalo, all those games happening tonight. The only game tomorrow is soccer playing Buffalo at Buffalo in the Mid-American Conference Championship quarterfinals. We'll step aside. Referees are back on the ice. We'll be back in just a moment. Stand by here. We'll be back with the second period here on CCHN. Both teams back on the ice here at Saginaw Bay Arena. We are just about set for period number two. Chippewas right to left across your radio dial. We're wearing the maroon jerseys with gold trim, gold numerals, gold helmets, maroon pants, maroon socks. Saginaw Valley left to right, blue numerals on their white jerseys, blue shoulders, red pants, and white socks. Face off at center. We are underway for period number two. Off of a tie-up, that was a lengthy tie-up, about 7 seconds worth. It's played into the Chippewa end to our right. Charlie Hayes back to play it. He'll play it off of the end board to Alex Lasky across the way. He gave it away behind it, and a pass up in front was deflected there by a good defensive stick of the captain, Keelan Baker. Right point, it's played off the boards and down low. There's Brandon Marshall. He had the goal last night to give the Cardinals the win. He couldn't corral it, and the Chippewas lifted back out to the offensive zone. There's Bruce McLean picking up the puck, moving it ahead to Nelson across the line right side. Oh, again a shot kicked away by the left pad of Thomas Rofe, ricochets to the near corner. It's played down low along the half boards. Players tie up. Jacob Costin kind of able to handle it a little back out to center ice. Ahead to Brandon Marshall on left wing. He couldn't corral, and the Chippewas send it off the boards with a minute gone here in period number two. Long stretch pass to nobody in particular. Icing will be waved off for some reason as Garrett Sawyer was behind the defense and he worked in. Icing should have been waved off, but the front linesman called it. And they'll have the draw out at center. We have a center ice dot. And the Saginaw coaches, Brendan Ryan and Lucas Cully, talking with the referees, wondering why the draw's at center. And the referees are explaining to them. So we'll have a draw at center once again. Simon Sully digging in. He lost the draw, but the Chippewas get it right back. Owen Campbell's pass across was intercepted, and Dornseifer leads the rush up left wing. Good defensive play as from behind him, Kyle Chapman knocked the puck away. The puck bounces around a neutral ice. San Andre chased after the puck, couldn't get to it in time. Garrett Sawyer plays it up off the boards and back to the Chippewa line. Well, Christopher Martin will play it ahead. He had it intercepted, but it bounces onto the stick of Campbell. Campbell toe drag into the bottom of the left circle. Fed it out in front, and Simon Sully took a tumble. Owen Campbell just took down his man in the left corner, and that has to be a penalty. He took his man down. That'll be a tripping minor. At least it should be. Otto and Campbell. Chippewas have to be careful here. They can't give the Cardinals any more opportunities than they deserve. And they're gonna send Campbell off with a misconduct. That's gonna be a 5-minute major for a trip? That is something I have never seen. My guess is it's gonna be for unsportsmanlike conduct. He's either got a 5-in-game or a 5-in-10. My guess it's gonna be a 5-in-game. And now Brennan Martin's talking to the referees. He's confused about it. So we have 5-minute all-you-can-eat power play here for Saginaw Valley. We'll await the announcement on the... That's a huge loss for the Chippewas. Campbell is one of their best, is their leading scorer on the year thus far, and he's a really good penalty killer as well. Draw in the Chippewa in, and it'll be a 5-minute power play. This could be disastrous. They call it a slew foot. Interesting. So a 5-minute major in the game misconduct for slew footing on Owen Campbell. At 1:42 of the second. Saginaw Valley works left to right on the attack. Garrett Sawyer plays it across to Dornseifer. Dornseifer back to Kukla. Kukla left point, works it down low along the boards to Dornseifer. He'll work it behind. Here we've got half a minute gone on the man advantage. Dornseifer across the way at the hash marks, works it up top to Kukla. Kukla feeding it near side to Sawyer in the circle. A shot, save the rebound, loose in front. And it's worked to the point. Kukla keeps it in. Near side to Sawyer, top of the right circle. Oh, feed into the slot. It's knocked away. And leading the rush here is Joey Simoncelli. He gets hooked from behind. Where's the call? It's not coming. 55 gone here in the man advantage. Working up over the line. Here's Kubiak. Kubiak sends it near side to Sawyer. It was intercepted. Chippewas come away shorthanded. Here's Cooper. Who let a shot go? Saving the rebound. It's clear to the near side. Now the Cardinals have numbers. Working a drop pass for Dornseifer, right point. He's pinned to the boards, puck loose in the corner. It's fished out of there by Jordan Cooper. He will backhand that out and out to center. 1:25 gone in the man in the 5-minute major to Owen Campbell. He was also sent off for a game misconduct. They ruled that his trip was slew footing. I saw a trip and that was it. Again, I'm also at center ice, not down in the left wing corner. Now, Saginaw Valley looking to go to work offensively. Nemeth left circle, a shot, right that wide, short side. It's kept at the line near Bruce McLean. McLean sends it out in front. Nemeth directed it wide of goal, but Thomas Roof there to make the save with 1:58 gone in the man advantage. And again, it is a 5-minute major, so the Cardinals can score as many times and not have the man replaced for the Chippewas. They also have lost Owen Campbell with a game misconduct. Their leading scorer is a shot from the right point. Deflected wide, bodies out in front, looking to stuff that home. Across the way, it's worked up top, Rowling. Rowling sends it back across. Working in, a shot, hit a body out in front, the rebound. Played in front, a shot, save, the rebound is cleared by the Chippewas. Good job there. In front of Thomas Roof, working defensively. 15:52 left here in the second period. 2:33 left in the Owen Campbell 5-minute major. Nemeth plays it off of his skate across that line right side. He'll work down into the corner and behind the net. He's knocked off the puck, but he'll regain it at the hash marks across the way at the boards. He'll send it near side, Rowling, top of the right circle. He'll work to the point, he'll send it back across to Nemeth. Nemeth had it knocked away from him, and the Chippewas are unable to get it out. Good play at the line. Now Nemeth working into the slot, ripped a shot, and he scores! and he falls down. The Chippewas have to maintain composure here as Nemeth ripped the shot into the top left corner. And it is now 3-0 in favor of the Cardinals. That was made possible by a keeping at the line as the Chippewas, Keegan Moore, tried to clear it out, but it was unsuccessful. And that led, that puck came right out of the stick of Nemeth. And it is a 3-0 hockey game at 4:39.
Score by number 25, Travis Nemeth, assisted by number 11, Brett Nelson.
Play back underway down below us here. Still a minute and 57 left on the 5-on-4. 5 minute major to Owen Campbell for slew footing. Dornseifer works across the line works across the center red line to negate the icing and throws it around the boards. Chippewas get it back and throw it down the ice. 1:41 left here in the man advantage. Isaac Gibbs on the forecheck picks up the puck, throws a shot, Bengals shot right on, and Winters was able to hold on to it. Moving forward, the Chippewas need to maintain their composure. Things seem to be getting a little bit more physical and a little bit more chippy as we go on. Now a Chippewa man is taken down in the corner, and there's another penalty. And Shaheen gets the stick knocked away from him, and that might negate the power play for the 4-on-4. As I said, composure needs to be maintained, and Isaac Gibbs slashes the stick out of Shaheen's hands, and we remain at a 4-on-3. That penalty will come at 5:33. And the referees are consulting in front of the penalty bench. 1:20 still left on the man advantage. Brennan Martin coming out to do his work as captain from the bench. So it'll be a 4 minute and a 2 minute. Okay, so there's gonna be two. Okay, so we're working out here 2 minutes on Isaac Gibbs. My guess is for a slash. And 4 minutes on Shaheen, on Aaron Shaheen. That should lead to a 2 minute advantage in favor of the Chippewas. They're going to put up 2 minutes for Aaron Shaheen, but he's actually got 4. Again, wait for an announcement on the penalties. Here it is. So it'll be a 4-on-4 for the next 1 minute and 20. Chippewas will have a 40-second power play as Shaheen gets the extra bit of penalty time out of that exchange. So Gibbs and Shaheen both whistled off for unsportsmanlike conduct. Shaheen also off for a trip. Drone will come back into the Saginaw Valley end. It will be 4-on-4. So things getting chippy here in the second period between these two clubs. There's not been a pretty hockey game, to say the least. 3 goals for the Cardinals, all of them on the power play. The most recent one coming from Nemeth at 4:39 here in the second. Chippewas lost the draw and have to go play it back in their own end after the Cardinals dumped it in. 1:06 left on the 4-on-4. Christopher Martin plays near side in his own corner. Right to left go the Chippewas here in period number 2. Simon Telly cross ice feed to Campbell. He's streaking through center ice with St. Martin. With St. Andre working in near side. Hope to Christopher Martin, but he lost control of the puck, but he'll get it right back to Campbell. And he threw it out to center off the boards. Now Simon Telly working well, the power play. No work in, knocked off the puck.
Central Michigan has returned.
And the Chippewas are now on the power play here. Now working up short-handed, here is Kyle Kubiak, tries to split the defense. He lost control of the puck, but it's right back onto the Cardinals stick. Now it's sent, now a loose puck in the bottom of the right circle. Cardinals wanting a penalty, none forthcoming. Now working out down right wing, Simon Selle hooked from behind, no call. He'll work into the right corner. Taken into the circle, back up top for Martin. Martin across to the right circle for Cooper. Back up top, they've got 2 seconds left on the man advantage, and they the Cardinals are back to full strength. Leading 3-0 here, they're able to kill off that abbreviated power play. So, the Chippewas are 0-for-1 on the power play here in this second period, and the Cardinals, by dint of that being a 5-minute major, by dint of that being a five-minute major, they are 1-for-2 with that power play goal from Nemeth. Puck played at center, near side, working over the right line, or over the line right side. But play ahead from Baker, intended for Marshall. He couldn't corral it. Marshall tied up in the far corner. Puck free behind Roof. Puck playing the Chippewa end, 2-1, right, 11:50 to go here in period number 2. Captain at the line, near side, Hudson. Hudson will work it into the circle. Along the boards, drop pass intercepted by the Chippewas. They send it out, and that'll go down. Icing is waved off. Icing is waved off, interestingly, as Schneider beat his man to the puck. But that was after the puck had crossed the line, crossed the goal line. Now the Chippewas go to work, but Alex Lasky, he had his shot blocked and moved out to center. Now Charlie Hayes over the line. Oh, we're getting the circle and a shot go right on. And Jacob Winters is able to hold on with 11:15 to go here in the second. 3-0, the Cardinals lead in a packed Saginaw Bay Ice Arena here tonight. The crowd has not disappointed. It's a little bit scant here due to this being the night before Halloween on a college campus, but they have turned out in droves, and they've got plenty of red in the stands, along with some scattered maroon and gold, with the Chippewa fans coming out with the trip to the east there from Mount Pleasant to Saginaw. Puck in the offensive end for the Chippewas, tied up near side. Charlie Hayes lost an edge, but he's able to recover and knock the puck away at center. Puck played inside the Chippewa line, near side, Charlie Hayes. Works defensively, he's worked off the puck. Cardinals feed it out in front, loose puck in the crease. And Thomas Roof is there to hold on, and there's gonna be another penalty coming up, and that's gotta be taunting. Come on, Brendan Hacker came out of that. He's chirping at the Chippewas. How is that not a taunting penalty? My goodness. This has been a very, very penalty-ridden second period as Charlie Hayes is going to go for a cross-check to put the Cardinals back on the power play here at 9:20. So the Cardinals, having already scored 3 power play goals tonight, they are 3-for-4, an incredible 75% on the man advantage here. And they'll get another chance to go to work as Charlie Hayes goes to the box for 2 minutes for a cross check. Chippewas win the draw, but can't get it out. Sawyer keeps it in right point. A pass across back to Sawyer, top of the right circle. He had it knocked away from him, and the Chippewas are able to get it off of Dornseifer, skating out to center. It's played back to the line. It'll be controlled by the line net by Nemeth. Ahead to Dornseifer across the line left side. He'll pull up top of the circle along the boards, looking for a pass to the near side, and Sawyer had a gaping net, and he fanned on the one-timer. Now Rychek ahead, near side, back across to Rychek. He lost control of the puck, and they score! Ben Rychek gets the Chippewas on the board on a broken play out in front, and the Chippewas get back within 2. It's 3-1. A shorthanded goal for the Chippewas,
All the goals in this contest have come on the have come an odd man situations, and Rychek getting the Chippewas on the board for the first time tonight. It's 3-1. Rychek was in there with Keegan Moore. And they got the Chippewas on the board. It's worked up top. Across, a shot through traffic was blocked down. Foot the rebound loose in the slot. And Nader was able to pick it up, kept in the line. Blocker saved there by Loaf. Saginaw still on the power play here. A pass across, a one-timer, a big save by Loaf. Coming on a shot from the left circle. Puck free in the left corner. Saginaw comes out with it, a shot off the side of the net. Coming off of Nemeth, he was bidding for another goal. That would have been his second of the night. It's worked up top. Rowling dances around an opponent. It's cleared out to center by the Chippewas. Good job there. Now Baker, he gets pushed down. That's going to be, and the Chippewas are going to get a penalty out of this. You have got to be kidding me. Baker was knocked down. He was fighting for the puck, and he's going to get a penalty out of it. This is absolutely ridiculous. The referees have lost all control of this game in due part to them making awful calls like this. Time of the penalty is going to be 10:48. The Chippewas are going to be on 5-on-3 here on an inexplicable call by the referees. Charlie Hayes still in the box for another 33 seconds. Chippewas have got a shorthanded goal to bring them back within two, but they're down by two men here as they sort out the penalties down below us. So they're still sorting out the penalties. Here's the announcement. And they're gonna give another. And they're gonna give Justin McComas a penalty too. It'll be 5-on-3 with stacked penalties. This is unheard of. My goodness. McComas to the box. Along with McComas to the box along with Chapman. It'll be a 5-on-3 for the next 4 minutes. for the next 4 minutes. It's cleared out by the Chippewas. Good job to win the offense, to win the defensive zone draw and send it the length of the ice. 9:02 left here in period number two. Chippewas 5-on-3 for the next 3:42. Down on the left wing, it's worked up top. Dornseifer controls top of the left circle, feeds it up top for Kubiak, top of the slot, across to Dornseifer at the left dot. We'll work it back up top, near his side as Hayes comes out of the box, but he has to stay there. It's still a 5-on-3 as the penalties stack. Work down low, Dornseifer right circle, passes up top to Sawyer, hold it, a shot goes save, and the rebound is cleared out by the Chippewas. Good job there by Jordan Cooper. Across the way, entering the zone is Kubiak. The Cardinal captain controls across the way, up top to Dornseifer. He'll work to the top of the slot. Uncontested, a shot, he scores! 4-1! The Cardinals lead another 5-on-3 goal. Another power play goal for the Cardinals. They have been unstoppable on the man advantage. Here as 59 seconds left in the penalty to Campbell. It's another 5-on-3 goal. This one coming at 11:49. It was a good shot by the Saginaw, by Sawyer. He worked to the top of the slot and rifled it into the top left corner, past right in the top of the right corner, or top right corner, past the right shoulder of Thomas Rolfe. It's now 4-1 in favor of the Cardinals. 1:32 still left on the man advantage. It's now 5-on-4.
So Kubiak and Kukla getting the assists on that goal. Rowling controls, still in the power play for another 104. Across the way, a feed out in front. The Chippewas are there. They get it to the line and out past Bruce McLean, who's unable to control it. All the goals in tonight's contest have come on an odd man situation. And we're going to have a penalty here. Interference. It's going to be on Jacob Winters here. This is something you don't often see. The Cardinal goaltender is going to have a penalty called on him. They're going to have to put somebody who was on the ice at the time of the penalty into the box. So it'll be 4-on-4 for another 46 seconds. This coming at 12:35. Puck played behind the net, 7:19 to go here in period number two. Chippewas and Saginaw Valley State, that's thrown down the ice. Icing will be the call with 33 seconds left on the 4-on-4. Fans, this is just a reminder that the broadcast of today's game is a copyrighted presentation of the American Collegiate Hockey Association and the CMU Club Hockey Network. No reproduction, retransmission, or other distribution of the descriptions or accounts of this game may take place without the express written consent of the ACHA and CCHN. Chippewas go to work on the 4-on-4. A shot whistled wide off the stick of Christopher Martin. Rebound corralled in the corner there by Ethan Schneider. He's leading the rush across center ice. Oh, looking at the left circle, a shot. Ripped that wide, pardon. And the puck comes free on the near side. It's tied up there. Brandon Marshall working there with Andrew Porzondik. Porzondik worked from behind by McLean. And the Chippewas are back to full strength and are on the power play here. Working out here shorthanded is Brett Nelson. He's taking hard to the boards at the line. Near side along the boards. Now a pass, here's Gibbs in. Gibbs, we get a shot, he scores! Isaac Gibbs on the power play! And the Chippewas are back within two. It is 4-2, Isaac Gibbs striking at 13:37. Gibbs picked up an outlet pass from the right side of the Chippewa head. It made its way all across the ice. Gibbs picked it up just outside the line on the left side, worked into the left circle, and picked the corner out from Jacob Witters, and it's a 4-2 hockey game now. Chippewas get that goal right back again on the power play. That'll be an icing call on the Chippewas here with 6:18 to go in the second. We still await the announcement on the second Chippewa goal here. Cardinals work it up top. After winning the draw, it's played out to center by the Chippewas. Cooper works it over the right line, right side into the circle, and backhand shot. Whistled that wide. Now, Dorn Seifer picks up the loose puck at his own line. He's across the offensive line. Nice toe drag around, but it is offside. His move at the line to get around Keelan Baker brought his man offside on the 2-on-1, and will have a draw just outside the Chippewa line on the near side. 14:01. Gone here in period number two, an eventful game thus far. We've had plenty of penalty minutes and plenty of goal scoring, all of which have come as the result of those penalties. All of the goals we've had, four power play goals, 1 5-on-3, and a shorthanded goal. All here in the first 35 minutes. Now working out through center, Keelan Baker shut off. And the Cardinals work in left side. Working in, a shot from distance, glove down there by Rofe. A shot from the left circle came off of the stick of Daniel Hudson. And there will be a draw in the Chippewa end. 5:31 left here in the second period of play. Chippewas gain control. Brendan Martin in the defensive end. Long outlet pass intended for Keelan Baker, and that'll go for an icing against the Cardinal, or against the Chippewas, pardon. With 14:39 to go, or 13:49 gone, pardon, in the second. Fans, stick around for the second intermission report. We'll have a recap of this messy second period. We've had lots of penalties, starting with that five-minute major to Owen Campbell, who, if you're just joining us, has been whistled off of the game. It's kind of, look out, the puck comes out of the playing surface and into the grandstand to our right in the Chippewa end. That'll be a draw in the Chippewa end as that puck was cleared out by the Chippewas. Draw on the right circle to the left of Thomas Rove. And since that game misconduct for Owen Campbell, the Chippewas leading scorer, it has been a flurry of penalty minutes. Now a shot from the right, top of the right circle was blocked. That could have been trouble in front of Thomas Rofe, but it deflected the corner safely. Shaheen entering the zone, lost the puck. Puck popped up in the air, picked up by Gazdecki. Gazdecki ahead on left wing to Porzondik. He'll pick up the puck left circle, a shot. And that's blockered up and into the netting there by Jacob Winters. Good job by him to knock the puck up into the netting. .452 left here in period number two. Chippewas and Saginaw Valley in a tight battle here. Now Gazdecki is sent out of the faceoff circle, shaking his head. He doesn't know why he was sent out. And he's talking to the linesman here. He's got to be careful. There's some faceoff confusion here as Gazdecki and Porzondik are both at the faceoff dot. Gazdecki's still protesting his expulsion from the faceoff circle with the linesman. I don't think there's... Oh, actually, we're waiting for a puck. Oh my goodness, we were waiting the entire time for a puck to be put back in play as that puck went up and out of the zone. So it'll be Gazdecki to dig in after a long delay. He'll win the draw. It's thrown around the boards by Charlie Hayes across the way. Andrew Porzondik picks it up. He'll feed it out in front. Nobody there to pick it up. Porzondik lets a shot go, deflected, and the rebound to the side of the net. Gazdecki down low. Behind the net, it's picked up by Porzondik to Gazdecki. Porzondik lost the puck. And so did Gazdecki, and Shaheen will play it out to center for the Cardinals. It's played back in by the Chippewas. Loose puck left in the circle. Diving for it is Porzondik, but he's unable to pick it up. He'll intercept the pass now, working to the right circle. A pass out in front, intercepted. Kept it at the line, though, by Charlie Hayes. And his fluttering shot was turned aside by Winters. Now puck free behind the net. Porzondik diving at it, but he knocks it away. Cardinals have numbers the other way. 4-on-3. Over the line, Shaheen near side. He'll work into the circle. Feeding in front. A shot that's kicked away by Rolf. And now Simon Selle with speed across the line. Had the puck knocked away from him. Good back check there by the Cardinals. 3:48 to go here in the second. Now here are the Cardinals. And there's going to be a penalty here as Charlie Hayes goes down. It'll be a rough, and Charlie Hayes is shaken up after the play. I didn't really see that one as Hayes came across the line.
He just got ran into.
So Hayes gets roughed up, and there'll be a penalty here as the Saginaw band starts playing Hooked on a Feeling to our right. Matthew Carter off at 16-18 for a rough. That'll put the Chippewas on a power play here for the next 2 minutes. They've converted on one power play thus far, one of their two goals. Puck tied up behind. There's going to be a penalty here. It's going to be a hold on Jordan Cooper that'll negate the penalty. And he is shaking his head. He has no idea why he's getting called. He was knocked down, trying to get up. He's going to be sent to the box for his trouble. Time of the penalty, 16:26. So Cooper sent to the box. The alternate captain, it'll be 4-on-4, negating the Chippewa power play. Many of the Chippewa fans, including yours truly, baffled by that penalty call, as we have been baffled all night. But we continue as a late hit on Alex Lasky, and that one isn't going to be called. My goodness. 3:16 left here in the second. Across the way, Rowling is tied up in the defensive end. Saginaw zone to our left. Saginaw Valley looks to move out here, moving with speed through the neutral zone. Over the line, Broski into the right corner. Working out, here's Keelan Baker. Baker sends a pass across to Simon Selle. We'll work it back to Lasky at center ice. He'll play it over to Brennan Martin. He'll tee it up and throw it around the boards. 1:03 left in the 4-on-4, and there's going to be a penalty here as Nick Broski shoved St. Andre up in the head area, and he's going to get a penalty for his troubles. Another penalty here. And with at the 17-19 mark here, it's going to be Broski. And it'll be a 4-on-3. So Cooper off for a hold, and it'll be a rough on Broski. Now moving out here is Christopher Martin in the left circle of the offensive end. He'll work behind and across the way. He'll pull up top of the right circle, and he's worked up to the point uncontested. Down low near side to Gibbs, back up top to Martin. Martin across the way. Here's Baker, a shot blockered away. Good save there by Winters. 27 left on the 4-on-3. Here's a pass across. Gibbs couldn't handle it, and he can't control the rebound, and the Cardinals flip it out. That should do it for the 4-on-3. Chippewa should have time for one last rush if they hurry here. 1:53 left in period number two. Working out here is Christopher Martin. It'll be a 4-on-4 in 5 seconds. Martin back to Gibbs. He's working into the right circle, had it knocked away, and out of the box. There's going to be an opportunity, another penalty. Here goes Winter, but in works Carter on a breakaway, a shot save, and the rebound comes in the near corner. A delayed penalty coming up on the Chippewas. Isaac Gibbs unable to head it. Carter throws it in front, and Nemeth picks it up. Pass across is uncontested. Chippewas on the power play here, but only for a time. And now we have some extracurriculars after the whistle here. And this is turning into a very, very chippy game. Is that a Cardinal or a Chippewa down in the right corner? That's a Chippewa down in the right corner. We have a couple of penalties coming up here. It's Isaac Gibbs down in the right corner. He's able to get up another. Like, Gibbs was hit in the head earlier in the game. He gets up and he makes his way to the Chippewa bench. 1:19 left here in period number two, 4-2. The Cardinals lead this one. We'll wait to hear the announcement on the penalties here. They're sorting out the penalties down below us here at Saginaw Bay Ice Arena. Brendan Martin in there to talk. Isaac Gibbs has been sent off. So Gibbs is now figuring out that he's going to go serve a penalty, and he is not happy about it. It has been a very interestingly officiated game tonight. And it continues to be, the referees seem to have lost control of this hockey game here with 1:19 left in the second. 4-2, Saginaw Valley leads. We've had five goals on the power play, one goal shorthanded. So Isaac Gibbs has been whistled off. It'll be a 4-on-3 here. Why is it a 4-on-3? Actually, Jacob St. Andre has yet was lingering by the bench. I didn't see him in my count. So it'll be a 4-on-4. Gibbs sent off for a slash, and the Chippewas win it in their own end and send it out. Here's Jordan Cooper over the line, left side, working on a shot. He tried to pick the far corner of the net. He sailed it high. 1:04 to go here in period number two, 22 on the 4-on-4. Now Jacob St. Andre working with the puck. It's lost in his skates, but he picks it right back up. He'll let a drop pass go to Martin. A shot through traffic. That was blockered away. 9 seconds left in the 4-on-4. Chippewas will be on the penalty kill in a couple of seconds. Out at center ice, McLean forwards it on ahead. Loose puck in the right circle. Holmer, get a shot! Over the net of Thomas Rofe, and it's sent out. Chippewas now have a minute and 13 to kill, about 40 seconds of which will be in the next period, is just offside. Jordan Seifer brought the puck in, but across the way, it was Aaron Shaheen bringing the puck in just too far in time. So, draw at center ice neutral dot near side is one back to the Chippewa end, and they get it out. Steven Kukla there to play it for the Cardinals. Near side to Dornsever, he's over the line, splits the defense, but he lost the puck. Comes into the far corner, Dornsever there to chase it down. Kukla moves it right back down. Alex Lasky pinned up along the boards. Dornsever picks up the loose change. He's across the way, working up to Kukla. A shot through traffic. That was tipped and went wide, as that will do it for the second period of play, as a shot from the point was tipped out in front, but, and into the back of the net, but luckily for the Chippewas, time had expired on the second period. 41 seconds left on the Isaac Gibbs minor. We'll step aside here for the second period. When we come back, we'll have the third period of action, we'll have a recap of the second period on the second intermission report, and a look at the out-of-town scoreboard. You're listening to Central Michigan Hockey on the CMU Club Hockey Network. As we bring you back here inside Saginaw Bay Arena, I will apologize for my conduct in that second period. I got very much carried away with myself, and it's not how I want to present myself and CCHN. I do apologize for any conduct that I had in that second period that was unbecoming. And I, anyway, second period of action was quite eventful. Both teams scored two goals in that second, but it was also accompanied by an astounding 37 minutes of penalties in a 20-minute span. It has been a incredibly chippy and dirty game between these two teams. Referees have been calling a lot of penalties. Some can be could be deemed unnecessary. Some could be deemed a bit overreactionary. But also, it's on the players in the end to conduct themselves well. And they both teams have been getting a little bit out of control. A couple of key penalties. Owen Campbell getting called off for a slew foot at 1:42 into that second. He went off for a 5-minute major and a game misconduct that contributed to about half of the penalty minutes in that period alone. But still, there, other than that, there were a good 22 penalty minutes outside of that. And the goals in that period came Nestle Nemeth at 4:39 on the power play. Rychek, shorthanded at the 10-minute mark, made it 3-1. And then Dornseifer let a shot go from the top of the slot, picked the corner, passed Rofe on a 5-on-3 from Kukla and Kubiak at 11:48. Right after the Chippewas struck back, and then Isaac Gibbs let a shot go from the bottom of the left circle into the far on the penalty kill. No, on the power play here. Now we take a look at the out-of-town, scoreboard. The Grand Rapids Griffins tonight defeat the Milwaukee Admirals in Van Andel Arena in Grand Rapids by a score of 4-1. Milwaukee opened up the scoring, 1:34 in David Ferentz on a power play, and that was all Griffins from there. Jonathan Berggren at 8:59, Kyle Criscolo at 11:04, and Chase Pearson at 12:22. Here the Griffins a 3-1 lead after one, and then an empty netter at the end of it. Chase Pearson is second of the night at 17:04. Close it out for the Grand Rapids Griffins. As for the Detroit Red Wings, they lost to the Toronto Maple Leafs 5-4 here tonight. Jake Muzzin had the goal for had the goals in the first, along with had the goal in the first, along with to put the Maple Leafs up 1-0, and then Red Wings goals in the second. Philip Zadina, his second of the year. Michael Bunting got his third of the year to put Toronto back up on top, 2-1. Then Alexander Kerfoot made it a 3-1 game, 17 seconds into the third. Joe Valeno responded right back for the Wings. 3-2 was the score then. John Tavares at 7:47 made it a 4-2 game for Toronto. And Nemestikov at 10:11 of the third made it a 4-3 game. And then Mitch Marner made it a 5-3 game at 17:55. Philip Hronek got the Wings back within one at 19:31. But at that point, it was too little too late, and the Wings lose this one 5-4 in against Toronto. Other scores around the NHL: the Boston Bruins improved to 4-3 with a 3-2 shootout win over the Panthers. Devils knock off the Penguins 4-2. Sharks and Jets. Sharks win that one 2-1 in overtime. And all the other games are still in action. Blackhawks trailing the Blues 1-0, 5:30 left in the third. Wild and Avalanche. Avalanche lead that one 1-0, 7:23 left in the second. Oilers and Canucks scoreless through the first about 7 minutes of that one. Flyers and Flames scoreless through about seven as well. Predators beat the Islanders 3-2 in a shootout, and the Kings knock off the Canadiens 5-2. Well, that will do it for our second intermission report. We will step aside and be right back with the third period here on CCHN.
Both teams back on the ice down below us here at Saginaw Bay Arena. Reagan Cleaves back inside the broadcast booth with you here, bringing you all the action of this very eventful contest between the Central Michigan Chippewas and the Saginaw Valley State Cardinals. We've got 20 minutes on the clock, 41 seconds left in the Isaac Gibbs Minor for tripping in the closing minutes of the second, 37 minutes of penalties in that second period. And we are just about set and ready to go with 41 seconds left in one of those 37 minutes. We are underway here at Saginaw Bay Arena. Right to left go the Saginaw Valley State Cardinals. Moving it up right wing. They're moving up left wing, is Garrett Sawyer down low. He'll work it up to Shaheen. Shaheen out in the left circle. He'll work it up top to Dornseifer. Dornseifer left point, fakes the shot, works into the circle. He'll feed it out in front. It was knocked away, but not far enough as a shot from the point. Whistled right off the stick of Kubiak. Now across the way, Sawyer. Drop pass for Kubiak. Kubiak up to Sawyer, top of the slot. He'll work around a man, but it was intercepted. Here's Keegan Moore with speed. He couldn't handle the puck cleanly, and he gets belted up top. A big hit as he tried to cross the line. He's not happy about it. And play is back into the Saginaw end, and we're going to have a whistle here. Puck tied up along the boards. Referees blew the whistle. With 55 gone here in the third. Drum will come outside the Saginaw Valley line on the near side. It'll be Keelan Baker to dig in with Nemeth. Nemeth already has two goals tonight. It's cleared into the Saginaw end, and it's sent out to, it's up and out of play behind Winters. We'll have a loose puck. It's cleared to the line. And the net came off behind Thomas Rolfe. Those nets have been coming off with alarming frequency here. We do apologize if we have any ins and outs, if we have any cutting ins and outs of our stream here. We are experiencing some technical difficulties here at Saginaw Bay Ice Arena. The Wi-Fi has been pretty good, but it keeps cutting in and out as technology does. So we will, again, if it becomes too much of a problem, we will upload the recording as we have a stoppage of play. So there's an opportunity right out in front there by Matt McClellan. And there was a hand pass by Saginaw Valley. So last night, the Chippewas were the perpetrators of two hand passes, and tonight it's the Cardinals. Off of the tie-up, it's cleared out to center, taken there by Andrew Porzundik. Porzundik splits the defense, lost the puck though, and it's cleared to the line. Lasky kept it in, he'll play it down low, worked back up to McComas, he couldn't handle it, and it's picked up here by the Cardinals. Kyle Kubiak lost control of the puck in his own zone. Porzundik makes a nice move up to Nato, a shot, and it was denied there by Winters, and now numbers the other way for the Cardinal. Maroon jerseys with gold trim, gold numerals, and Central Michigan across the front, along with a small uniform, a small numeral. Now intercepting, here's a shot from McClellan, from McLaughlin, pardon. That was turned aside by Rofa off of the giveaway by the Chippewas. Now a stretch pass through a couple of, Saginaw Valley Chippewas, and a close icing call. Justin McComas not happy in the slightest with that icing call. He looked like he beat the man to me, but man, I didn't have the best angle. I'm not sitting right on the dot, so it is indeed an icing against the Chippewas here. 3:34 left here in period number three. It's wrapped around the boards across the way. Defensively, there is Alex Lasky. He's pinned up along the boards. Good work there by Daniel Hudson along the half wall. It's fished around to the near side. McLaughlin played it down low. Now feed out in front. A loose puck is intercepted there by Brennan Martin, and he churns the engine and moves up. He gets McLaughlin up high. No penalty coming. This game has gotten very physical here, and now we have a penalty whistle.
Not exactly sure why they blew the whistle there. Oh, there was an injured player down here. Sorry. He was hidden by the boys. Troy McLaughlin was down hurt along the near half wall. He was at the perfect angle. He was so close to the boards that I didn't see him along the half wall on the near side. He makes his way to the bench, a little shaken up, but he makes his own way to the bench. Looks to be at least okay to do that. I hope it's nothing more serious than that. Draw on the right wing circle. Alex Aiden Gazdecki wins it. A shot! Myerichek is right on. And Jacob Winters makes the save with 15:52 left here in the third. Now a shot by Rychek was blocked, and it's out to center. Right off of the draw. Christopher Martin plays it out to center, played by Rychek. Rychek back at his own line. He'll play it to the near side. Played there by Keelan Baker. Pardon me, Kyle Chapman. Now there's a giveaway in the slot. McLean couldn't corral the puck. He had a golden opportunity in the high slot if he could have corralled that to get a shot on goal on Rolf Point Blank. Rowling plays it near side at center. We'll throw it in. It's gloved down there by Christopher Martin. We'll send a saucer pass out to center. Rowling got into it with Cooper, but loose puck is picked up in the defensive end there by Nick Brusky. A shot from a shot. Bengal skidded across the face of goal. It was taken there by the Cardinals. It looked like a clearing attempt there by Garrett Sawyer, but he couldn't get any air under it. I'm not sure why it wasn't icing. It's cleared out to center. Loin Seifer plays in the official circle across the way. Goes in on Rolf. He plays it safely there to Kyle Chapman. Over 5 minutes to go here in period number 5 minutes gone here in period number three. Puck played just inside the Chippewa line. It's thrown to the near side off of a skate. Jordan Cooper plays it ahead. It was taken away from Kyle Chapman after he received the pass and goes back out to center. Delayed offsides here for the Chippewas. Now outlet pass was intercepted, and they're going to call icing on. That one is Dwayne Seifer. Couldn't get a handle on it, and he was beaten in the race. Another close race to the dot by Brennan Martin. If you're looking for any fans, if you're looking for any pictures of Chippewa Hockey Division 3, be sure to go to follow Instagram at Tristan Hogenstein Photography. That's on Instagram. We'll get you the exact spelling of that momentarily as play has resumed down below us. Cross ice pass catches Sawyer. He's in over the line on the left circle. A shot saved by Wolf and the rebound loose. And he's able to corral the bouncing puck and hold on. Rebound control has been very inconsistent for these two netminders over the last five plus periods. That was one of the weaknesses in the game last night for them. It didn't end up leading to any goals, but they were lucky on those. The handle for Tristan Hogelstein Photography is spelled as such. It's at capital TRISTAN capital H AGENSTEIN capital and capital P in photography. Photography is PHOTOGRAPHY. Puck play down the Saginaw Valley end to our right. Again, that Instagram is for photos of Chippewa hockey taken by Tristan Hagelstein. Now a shot from the top of right circle and a rebound! Kostnik lifted that just high. Simon Selle plays the loose puck behind the net. He's taken to the boards. It's fished up Austin Whaley, unable to handle it. Now Dwayne Seifer lost control of the puck at center, avoiding a rush. Simon Selle working on Dwayne Seifer. Now it's intercepted. Here's Brennan Martin. Martin working into the top of the slot. And a backhand shot wide near side. He tried to go back across the net with that shot, and he put it about a foot wide. Porzondik throws it around the boards from the right point, picked up across the way by Alex Lasky. It's wrapped up, couldn't be corralled by St. Andre, and Chippewas have to regroup. Over the line onside, a pass across from Porzondik was intercepted. Now the Cardinals right to left. Carter put a bounce pass off the boards, was intercepted, and now here's Porzondik with a rush. He'll work in over the line, into the shot, he scores! And
Your boys on Nick, and the Chippewas have come back with three unanswered goals that tie up the hockey game at 7:29. A big change of events here in the third period of play. Andrew Porzondik picked up a loose puck off of a skate, off of the boards, and into an odd hop off of a Saginaw Valley player along the boards across the way. And he picked up the puck, worked around the outside of the circle, and as a goaltender, Jacob Winters was up against the post, but he didn't have the entire post covered, as Porzondik was able to sneak it short side and into the back of the net. There's a timeout on the ice. We will take one as well. You're listening to CCHN. The Chippewas with their leading scorer, Owen Campbell, out with a game misconduct, have managed to score three unanswered goals. One from Isaac Gibbs, one earlier in this period for the Chippewas, and Andrew Porzondik tying up the hockey game just moments ago with a shot from a sharp angle that beat Jacob Winters' short side. This, for certain, has not been the goaltender's night. Eight combined goals between these two teams has led to a fantastic fantastic hockey game, back and forth action in an MCHC division rivalry. Both these teams fighting for a hopeful game. Now a shot through traffic, caught Roof in the mask from the left point off of the stick of Schneider. Now the Chippewas. Here's McComas, a shy off of the shoulder of Winters, just narrowly wide. Now Nadeau getting cross-checked in the face, and that's going to be a penalty. Nadeau got chopped in the face, and the Chippewas are going to go on the power play here, and the momentum has swung from about 90 degrees all the way in favor of the Saginaw Valley end, and the pendulum has swung all the way back, and the momentum is in favor of the Chippewas, and they've got themselves a power play. Hudson being whistled off at 8:11. He's getting off for a rough, so the Chippewas back on a power play here. They're 1-for-6 on the evening. As we mentioned, lots of penalties in that second period. Now Simon Selle over the line, right side. He's working into the right corner. Down behind the net. Now the SVSU chant going down the student section, two on left. Play in the zone, a pass up top was intercepted. Baker up top to Lasky, left point. Lasky over to Baker, corrals the bouncing puck, throws it down low. Simon Selle, near side, Cooper. Cooper works it up top to Brennan Martin, right point. He'll work it down low to Cooper near side, and a shot, and the net is off of its moorings. The nets have been coming off the moorings all night, and I know the whole point of the net is to be able to break away easily so as not to cause injuries, but this has been, the nets have been as easy to knock off as to move a feather in the wind. It's been kind of embarrassing how easily the nets have been knocked off. Now an interception here. Shaheen working into the right circle. A shot kicked away by Thomas Rofe. A beautiful opportunity denying Shaheen shorthanded. Now the Chippewas, Baker moves into the offensive end. He gets drilled behind the net. Chippewas are screaming for a penalty, none forthcoming. A shot off the post, and the rebound. Who's the shot? That was denied. Cooper working down low. Back up is Keelan Baker. Chippewa bench still standing up there, incensed that wasn't called behind the net. Lasky across to Baker. Cooper, a pass out in front. It was tipped high by Lasky. Simon Selly down low. We'll pick up the puck across the way up top. Delasky back to Simon Selly. They change places. Simon Selly walks the line near side off the boards to Cooper near side. Cooper in the circle, feeds it up top. Simon Selly lost the puck. Brandon Martin across a one-time big save. Thunder off the pad of Winters. Rebound thrown to the near side halfway through this third period. Behind the net, Keelan Baker loses control and it's sent out, and that will just about do it for the Chippewa power play. Now a loose puck. Baker had it knocked away from Kukla. Fires a shot just high. Oh my goodness. Chippewas were caught in a line change. And now they have numbers back the other way. Cooper had the... Cooper was slashed. No call forthcoming. Now St. Andre sends it across. A one-timer was fanned on there by Mike Christopher Martin. Now the Chippewas play it down low. A pass out in front to nobody in particular. We'll go all the way back down the ice. This has turned into from a blowout into a thrilling hockey game here at Saginaw Bay Ice Arena. That should have been too many men on the ice on the Chippewas, but they get away with one. Now Kostek across the line outside. Deeks working into the bottom of the right circle and lets a shot go. And it is corralled there by the Cardinals. .906 left here in period number three. This has been a fantastic hockey game between these two clubs. It has been back and forth all night. They've had many opportunities. The first six goals of this hockey game were all scored on the power play. Now St. Andre, that's a shot, go! Oh, he ripped that just high and wide on the near side. He had all the time in the world and ripped it high. Now at center, there's some roughhousing going on at the opposite corner, opposite blue line. Now through center, St. Andre deeks around but lost the puck. It's corralled by Christopher Martin into the offensive end. Now an outlet pass, couldn't be corralled by Nemeth. That'll be an icing on the Saginaw Valley Cardinals. And if Nemeth can get a hold of that one, he has nothing but empty ice ahead of him and a great chance to break open this game once again in favor of the Cardinals. My goodness, the Chippewas catch a break there at the 11:25 mark of this third. Draw on the right circle, won by the Chippewas. It's worked up top. Charlie Hayes throws it down low behind the net. It's raced for it. Loose puck corralled there. Chippewas come out with the puck. They lose the puck, though, on the near side. Borzonda gets it right back, throws it out in front of a skate, and right back onto the Cardinals' hands. They've got numbers the other way. Borzonda coming back. Great back check. And they're going to call a penalty on it. That draws the ire of the Chippewa bench. They have been calling a lot of penalties, and it hasn't been consistent. They've been called evenly on both sides, but it has been anything but consistent in what they do call, and that is why the coaching staff of the Chippewas, Tyler Cataline and Tyler Koth, and the rest of the Chippewas on the bench are incensed. Either way, at 11:46 here, the third, Saginaw Valley has another power play. Sent near side, corralled by Dornseifer. Dornseifer works it up top. It's sent down low into the slot. A pass across, a one-timer shot was blocked. And the rebound is corralled. Here's Kukla. Kukla right circle, a shot, go right that short side wide. 7:54 left here in the third. Worked up top. Corralled there by Kubiak. Kubiak down low. Gets the return feed up at the point. Kubiak sends it near side. Dornseifer. Dornseifer, 30 seconds gone here in this man advantage. And a loose puck picked up at the Chippewa, picked up at the Saginaw line. Jay Nadeau working with speed there. Now Justin McComas putting on the pressure. But he's unable to stop the Cardinal rush. Now here's a shot by Sawyer. Ripped up into the netting above the ice. So we'll have a stoppage of play with 50 seconds gone in the penalty here to Andrew Porzonduk. Borzondig whistled off for a slash. Chippewas tonight are 6-for-10 on the penalty kill. 60%. That's a lot worse than their 91 coming into this game. Now pass across intercepted, and Kostnik falling to his knees is able to clear it down the ice and force Winters to hold on to that puck. Doing that was Keegan Moore. A great job by him to work down and pressure Jacob Winters and force him to pick up a loose puck. Now it's worked to the near side. Off of the offensive zone draw, won by the Chippewas. It's pinned to the boards. They're on the penalty kill. This is doing a great job here by the Chippewas. Now it's worked down across ice feed. Gloved down by Kostnik. This has been some great penalty killing here in the last minute and 30 for the Chippewas. Now Kostnik in with a shorthanded chance. Holwerk, he's drawn a penalty. And we will have a slashing penalty on Saginaw Valley. Jacob Kostnik doing a fantastic job to not only knock down the puck at center, but also work in shorthanded, drawing that penalty, and we'll have a 4-on-4 for the next 27 seconds. That penalty coming at 13:19 of this third period. Puck kept in deftly at the line there by Brennan Martin, who'll walk it to the far side, throw it down low there to Baker. Baker sends it near side. Nice play there by Dornseifer. It was actually Travis Nemeth in the penalty box, not Dornseifer. They announced Dornseifer. Now pass out in front, was deflected, and the rebound loose in front, and it is cleared out by the Saginaw Valley Cardinals, and they've got numbers. It's a 3-on-1. Kukla on their side. Oh, we get a shot right on it. Roof stands tall and makes the save. Travis Roof in the left facing a 3-on-1 came out to play the shot, leaving his defenseman to play the pass, and he made a key save here with 6:11 left here in the third. Chippewas have a power play here for the next 1 minute and 23 seconds. Left to right here in this third period of play. Reagan Cleaves inside the broadcast booth with you here on CCHN. Kevin Serra unable to make the trip. He will be back next weekend when the Chippewas have that home-and-home series against U of M Flint. Out played to the near side. Errant pass played off the half wall by Cooper. He'll make a nice pass there to Alex Lasky. He's through center. Over the line. Holwerk into the circle. A shot glove save by Jacob Winters.
Go Chips!
5:34 left here in the third period of play. A 4-4 hockey game. The Chippewas have made the improbable comeback after trailing this game 4-1 at one point. Gibbs and Porzondik both getting goals. Porzondik, or Gibbs, kicking off the comeback, and Porzondik finishing it off with a fluke of a goal at the 7:29 mark of this third. We've got 5 minutes to go here. 38 seconds left on the man advantage for the Chippewas. Pass up left wings. Gibbs sends it near side to St. Andre. Jacob St. Andre across that line. Holwerk into the slot. Loose puck bouncing away. And it's cleared out. Now it's a race for the puck. Great job by Carter to get around his man. Working in on Roof. And a big save there by the tall netminder in the maroon and gold uniform to our left. He stood tall. And a great shorthanded opportunity there for the Cardinals. Pass across, St. Andre controls. 5 seconds to go on the man advantage. St. Andre working at his own line, harassed there by Shaheen. St. Andre working to the top of the slot, into the left circle, working down low, goes behind the net, knocked off the puck, but he still pursues it. Great effort here by Jacob St. Andre, but not enough to keep the puck. Now moving out, here's a one-time blast. A shot saving the rebound, another blocked shot there by Isaac Gibbs, sacrificing the body here in the waiting minutes of regulation. Chippewas are able to clear it out to center ice and back into the Saginaw Valley, and they'll go for a change. Momentarily, Saginaw had numbers, but Chippewas are right back on the ice. Working down the left wing, near side is Brent Nelson. Nelson working it up top. A shot through traffic, saving the rebound off of the pad of Rolfe, and the Chippewas almost gave it away at the line, but were unable to do so. Adu comes off the ice. He's exhausted at the bench. He takes a seat, and the Chippewas regroup with 3 3/4 minutes remaining here in regulation, a 4-4 tie here at Saginaw Bay Ice Arena. A great conclusion to this weekend series. It has been close all weekend. Saginaw looked like they were going to come out on top early in this one, scoring 4 goals to Central Michigan's 1, but the Chippewas have come back, scoring 3 unanswered, and to leave us here. Now working in, here's McLean taking to the ice. Cardinal fans wanting a call, none forthcoming. It's worked out in front, bouncing puck, loose in the slot. It is cleared away. Chippewas have numbers. Here is Jordan Cooper, right wing, 3-on-2. He'll work over the line, let a wrist shot go blocked by the defense. Now he's taking the boards, wanting a call, none forthcoming. Jordan Cooper lost the puck behind the net. The Chippewas are forced to come back defensively. Up left wing, here's Broski. Broski lost the puck. Sawyer picked that up in the slot. Good defensive play there by the Chippewas to be able to knock that puck away from him. They're able to get it to the line. Dornseifer kept it in. He'll throw it down low to Sawyer. A pass right out in front was knocked away. They'll get the puck right back though, and McLean is unable to keep the pass in at the line. And it'll go all the way back into Saginaw territory. 2.5 minutes to go here in the third. Here's Dornseifer over the line. He tried to split the defense, and he's taken down. That looks dangerous. Knee-to-knee contact. He is down. Dangerous play there, and they blew the play dead, even though the Chippewas had the puck in their own defensive end. Dornseifer able to get up after a scary hit as he tried to split the defense. Looks like he hit his knee, and good to see him up. Knee injuries are scary, especially when it's knee-on-knee contact like that. Well, good to see Dornseifer get up, and he's making his way slowly to the bench. 17:40 gone here in the third period of play. It has been a massively unexpected game. We had 1 goal last night, and now we have a combined 8. And it has been a fairly even game the last couple of periods. First period didn't go so well for the Chippewas, as did the second, but they gained the momentum back at the end of that second with the Gibbs goal at 13:37. And we stand here at 4-4. Draw one by the Chippewas at neutral ice after that stoppage of play. They'll go to work defensively, try to break it out. Here's Brennan Martin, the Chippewa captain, plays it ahead. Chipped into the zone there by Baker. Baker down low to Simon Selle. Simon Selle will work behind the net. Looking for a pass up top. He's got Brennan Martin. Martin will throw it down low. Off the boards. Nadu fitted it in front. Nobody there at home for the Chippewas, but they keep it in. Here's side Simon Selle. Walks into the circle. Feeding it in front. Nobody home on the back door for the Chippewas. It's kept into line. Here's side Kostnik threw it. Whaley threw it down low. Loose puck to the sideboards. Thrown out to center ice. Taken there by Whaley. 1:43 to go here in regulation. 4-4. Chippewas and Saginaw Valley State Cardinals deadlocked at 4. It's played out. Here's Carter through neutral ice. Had his pass intercepted by San Andre. He was taken down. But the loose puck around by Gibbs ahead to Cooper, right wing. Cooper, Cardinals are caught in a line change. Hula shot, go block it away by Winters. Rebound is swept out to center ice. Play to the near side. Christopher Martin up to Cooper. Jordan Cooper bumped to the boards. And Isaac Gibbs applying the forecheck pressure. Here we've got 60 seconds left here in regulation. Puck played in the near corner boards in the Saginaw end to our right. They'll work right to left here in the waning minutes of this third period. The late offsides on the Cardinals here. Back at his own line to play it is Kyle Chapman. 39 seconds left here in period number 3. Kyle Chapman, a long pass ahead. Chippewas unable to control their own line. Cardinals back there by shot from distance, whistled wide. 25 to go here. It's play to the near side. Baker
couldn't corral it. Cardinals back to their own line. Across the way, it's picked up by Kubiak. Kubiak moving it ahead to Hacker. Hacker hip checked at center ice. They've got a chance. Working it all alone on Rolf. Just missed the net far side. Oh my goodness, Troy McLaughlin bidding for his second of the night. The Chippewas clear it down the ice, and there is a delayed penalty on the Cardinals. Chippewas will have a power play to start overtime. We will step aside here. A wild third period leads us to overtime for the first time this season. We will step aside and come back overtime on the other side. You're listening to CCHN. The prescription for tonight is a period of overtime. It'll be a 4-on-3, I believe, for the Chippewas to the box at the end of the period, right as the whistle blew. Hacker was sent to the box. And the Chippewas will have a full 2 minutes to go to work here on the power play in this overtime period. 4-on-3, Chippewas right to left, maroon jerseys, gold trim, gold helmets, maroon pants, maroon socks. Saginaw Valley left to right, white jerseys, red helmets, red pants, white socks. We've got 5 minutes on the clock. Sudden death overtime. It's actually going to be... It'll be 5-on-4, so... We're playing... The puck dropped at center, but we have a delayed offside. 5-on-5 overtime here. Interesting. Not how I would like to see it. NHL 3-on-3 has grown on me over time. Chippewas lose the draw at center. Have to go back to their own defense. Have to go back to their own defensive zone, working right to left here at the start of this overtime. Working up right winger Simon Selle ahead to Saint Andre. Saint Andre working it across. To nobody in particular as it was deflected. Jordan Cooper pinching down from left defense. He'll work into the corner. Good play there by the Saginaw Valley Cardinals. They can't control it though. Brennan Martin left point. He'll throw it down low to Cooper. Cooper back up top to Martin. He'll let a shot go through, saving the rebound. Loose in the circle. And it is cleared by the Cardinals, but kept in beautifully at the point by Martin. Their side Cooper. He'll throw it across. Nobody there to control for the Chippewas. It's worked up top, Brennan Martin right point, near side Cooper left point. He'll work in a shot through traffic, saving the rebound. Is fanned on the clearing attempt, but it's moved out to center nonetheless. 1:04 left in the man advantage. Baker had it caught in his skates, and the Cardinals will lift it in on a rope, but it trickles wide of goal. 52 seconds to go here in period number, in the overtime period. Working out with speed, Simon Selle across that line right side, 1-on-4. He'll work behind the net, still controlling the puck. He'll feed it out in front, St. Andre deflected it on the doorstep. but right into the pads of Jacob Winters. 1:24 gone here in period number three. Music being brought to you by the Saginaw Valley Cardinal Hockey Band. Up in the mezzanine to our left, Cardinals win the draw and send it the length of the ice. 1:30 gone in both the period and the man advantage. Chippewas, some miscommunication on the breakout, but they get it started. Hayes down right wing, will reach the red line, throw it around the boards. With speed, Jay Nadu picks it up in the near corner. He'll throw it up the boards near side. Isaac Gibbs, 1/4 minute left on the man advantage. Across the lane, shot through traffic, deflected in front to save, the rebound is cleared by the Cardinals right in on Rolf. He had to make a beautiful, he had to make a good save. They're staying on his toes. 2 seconds to go in the man advantage. Cardinals have killed off a vital 4-on-4 power play, overtime power play here. We're back to 5-on-5. McLean picks it up behind the net, throws it up the boards near side. Pinching down, oh, good play there by Charlie Hayes to keep control of the puck in Chippewa hands. 2:40 left here in the third period of play. It's worked up top. Cardinals have numbers. Here's Kukla over the line right side. He'll work to the top of the slot, feed it down low. Oh my goodness, that was tipped just wide. It's thrown around the boards to the near side, picked up by McLean. McLean bumped to the boards. Good defensive play there. Charlie Hayes throws it to the point, but not out. Kept in there by Kubiak. Kubiak will throw it down low. Isaac Gibbs intercepts it, though. And the Chippewas, right to left, come on the rush. Set across the way, 2:12 left here in period number three. Chippewas go off for a change. They are quick. They do it quickly so as not to be caught on an odd man rush. Now it puck trails in on Rolf. He will come out and cover it. And Austin Whaley giving an extra little bit of a shove to Travis Nemeth, who came in, did not go to Rolf. And to his credit, he did not run into Rolf. He stopped and he put his hand up as if to say, I'm sorry. But Austin Whaley, to get him away from his netminder, kind of took him off, or kind of held him and shoved him off. But nothing comes of that. Saginaw Valley wanted a penalty, but that won't happen. Draw on the left wing, or draw on the right wing, circle to the left of Rolf. Draw controlled off the draw by Simon Sully. He has been very good on the faceoffs here tonight. Now a one-touch pass ahead to Brennan Martin. Near side, Simon Sully picks it up from behind him. Simon Sully moving in ahead to Martin. A shot right on! And a big save there by Jacob Winters. 1:44 left in overtime. 4-4. Here, Chippewas tied it up with 3 unanswered goals. Drawing the offensive end, Chippewas can't control. It's 4-on-4 hockey here. It's thrown up the wing. Shaheen over the line right side, 3-on-2. Feeds it in front to Carter. Carter working in a shot. Big block there by Martin. He'll throw it around behind. Nobody there to pick it up. Loose puck across the boards. Worked out by St. Andre. St. Andre didn't have enough speed and didn't have full control of the puck, so he pulled up. We'll give it to Brennan Martin. Offside! You've got to be kidding me. Oh, my goodness. The Chippewas had the opportunity of a lifetime. Brennan Martin working in the right circle, and his man along the boards across the way was offsides. Saginaw Valley catching a break there. Final countdown being pumped out of the musical instruments from the Saginaw Valley Band to our right. Andrew Porzundik couldn't corral it. It's sent down into the Saginaw Valley end. Alex Lesky couldn't corral it at the line, but he'll get it right back. It's sent across from Porzundik to Martin. Martin finds Lesky streaking up the left wing, but it was intercepted. It was deemed to be tipped by the linesman. 1 minute to go here in 4-on-4 overtime. It's fed out in front. Nobody home there for the Chippewas. McLean clears it to the line, but not out. Good keep there by Christopher Martin. It's thrown to the near corner on the boards. Kostic picks it up. He's got an opportunity, but he lost the puck. It's worked up to the point. Alex Lesky fishes it down low, and that's going to come outside the Saginaw Valley end with 38.6 seconds left here in overtime. This series
all weekend has been a tight contest. Things got a little bit out of hand in that second period, both up here in the broadcast booth and down on the ice. 37 minutes of penalties, but nonetheless, Chippewas have tied up this hockey game. That's Isaac Gibbs across the way. Had the puck knocked away from him. Working in with Alex Leske. Cardinals get it out to center. Christopher Martin sends it near side to Jordan Cooper. Cooper working up through center. Over the line, working into the left corner. All worked down behind. 20 seconds to go here in overtime. It's worked up top. Thrown down low, but it was blocked by a Cardinal on front. Now a feed out in front. It was deflected out to center. Christopher Martin's got to be careful with what he does with the puck here. It's sent down to the Saginaw end, and that'll do it for overtime. And that will do it for this one. A 4-4 tie between these two clubs. Well fought this weekend series. A fantastic hockey game here tonight. As we end in a 4-4 tie from Saginaw Bay Ice Arena. We'll step aside for one final time, and then we'll come back with a full recap of this one. You're listening to Central Michigan D3 Club Hockey on CCHN.
If one were to write the headline for a game report of tonight's game, the headline would most certainly be Central Michigan Chippewas win by a score of 4-4. Chippewas had had a miraculous comeback starting late in that second period when they were down 3-1. Or 4-1, Isaac Gibbs kicked things off at the 13:37 mark, and the Chippewas were off and running, and they got two goals in that third. The final one coming from Andrew Porzondik to bury it short side, and the Chippewas come away. Although it wasn't the result they wanted, they will most certainly take a tie the way this one started. It was not pretty, to say the least. They had two penalties in the first period, and both of them wound up with power play goals for Saginaw Valley State. McLaughlin and Dornseifer capitalizing on those two power play opportunities they were gifted by Austin Whaley. There was a 5-on-3 in there for the Chippewas. Nemeth and Morgan went off at the same time for two different infractions on the same delayed penalty call, and then Chippewas couldn't do anything, so they were 0-for-2 through the first period. Then all mayhem broke loose in the second period. A combined 37, yes, I said 37, penalty minutes in the second period. And there were four goals as well. Nemeth made it 3-0 from Nelson at 4:19. Then Rychek capitalized shorthanded on with a feed from Keegan Moore at exactly 10 minutes, exactly the halfway point of the hockey game, and from there it seemed like things were turning in favor of the Chippewas. Now, although Dornseifer got a goal a minute and 49 seconds later from Kukla and Kubiak on a 5-on-3, the momentum seemed to be turning a little bit in the Chippewas' favor with that goal. Isaac Gibbs, 2 minutes after that, we had three goals in the span of 3:37. Rychek, Dornseifer, and then Isaac Gibbs getting the Chippewas back within two at the 13:37 mark. And as I said earlier, things were off and running. Chippewas were able to tie up at the 7:49 mark. They kept the pressure on, but were unable to do anything with it. They got a gift of a power play at the 20-minute mark of the third, so that carry over into overtime. But they couldn't do anything with it, falling to 1-for-9 on the night, and the Cardinals were 5-for-11. And it is a good night whenever, or pardon me, 4-for-11. It is a good night whenever you can get four goals on the power play, even if it is a tie. And Saginaw has some, they are definitely looking up when it comes forward looking forward ahead later on this season. Overtime, much to my chagrin, ended in a tie. I definitely think I have some opinions on ties and whatnot, but we will save them for later. Safe to say, I do not like ties, and I think we should find a way to get around them with a shootout or 3-on-3 overtime or something like that. Anyway, Central Michigan falls to 3-1-1 on the air. Saginaw Valley goes to 3-2-1, and they once again are tied in the standings, dead middle of the MCHC West, tied both with 10 points, and Central Michigan still ahead in third. Saginaw Valley second due to playing one more game than the Chippewas and thus having a lower points per game ratio. Well, we'll take one last look at the out-of-town scoreboard here. Grand Rapids Griffins again beating the Milwaukee Admirals 4-1. The Detroit Red Wings losing to the Maple Leafs by a score of 5-4. And the Saginaw Spirit are in action on Wednesday. Well, before we step aside, we've got three stars of the game. I jumped ahead in my script a little bit here. Three stars of the game. Travis Nemeth had two goals. He only had one goal. Dornseifer actually had two goals. He is our first star of the game. Isaac Gibbs kicking off the comeback for the Chippewas at 13:37 of that third period, of that second period. And Andrew Porzondik getting the third star of the game with that game tying goal. Next games for both of these clubs. Saginaw Valley State travels to to Cedar Springs, Michigan, to take on Ferris State University at Cedar Rock Sportsplex, Ava Glavin Ice Center up in Big Rapids for Ferris State is otherwise occupied on Friday, so they moved down to their second home, the Cedar Rock Sportsplex down in Cedar Springs. As for Central Michigan, we will be right back on the air on Friday with a 4 p.m. broadcast from Martin Ice Arena as the Central Michigan Chippewas host yet another MCHC West opponent in the University of Michigan Flint Wolverines. We'll have a 4 p.m. broadcast. We'll go on about, depending on when warm-ups start, we'll go on anywhere from 4 to 4:30. We will check our Twitter for more detailed information as that game approaches. Well, we'd like to thank SVSU and the staff here at Saginaw Bay Ice Arena for helping us get set up here at a pretty nice vantage point, dead center ice. And it was a great vantage point in this old barn to get a view of this fantastic hockey game. The fans were rocking, and the band was adding some great atmosphere, and it was a great hockey game, minus the 37 minutes of penalties in the second. It was a great hockey game to watch here tonight. Well, that will just about do it for us this evening, but we'll be back next Friday when the Chippewas host the Michigan Flint Wolverines. Until then, this is Reagan Cleaves saying so long from Saginaw Bay Ice Arena in Saginaw, Michigan, as the Chippewas and Central Michigan Chippewas and the Saginaw Valley State Cardinals come to a 4-4 draw. Thanks for listening.